brand new banger. Banger.
What is your hatred for John Cena?
Yo, when Hulk Hogan takes a rock bottom better than you, there's a problem. There's a problem. My man. All right, so give me the camera.
One rock bottom. Yo,
no. It's more than that, show. Give me the camera. I got the fucking camera. Kenny, I'm gonna have to do it for you. I'm gonna give you the whole spiel. He came out as a prototype.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. You know, he slaps Kurt Angle. Rude disaggression. I'm not into that. Whatever. He comes out as a rapper. I'm like, okay, all right. I can dig it. You know, he got, you know, he's from Boston, so that's a strike. You know, us New Yorkers, we don't fuck with Boston too much, but you know what? I'll look over that. He's doing his thing. Something original. There's something different. It's entertaining. Comes around, and my man has a choice between The Big Show, Kane, or Shawn Michaels. And he gives the most pussiest promo I've ever heard in my life. I will never forgive this. And he's on some, well, you know, I don't want to fight The Big Show because, you know, he's a huge guy. And, you know, you got the big red machine. Who wants to fight him? And Shawn Michaels is a legend. Fuck that, bro. You already beat all these motherfuckers already.
Her return on SmackDown.
Okay.
So I definitely read some rumors about that.
Because for whatever reason, and I don't know Cody's reason, you turn around and go back, and people are going to be, you destroyed thrones, and you go back? We have been doing this shit for ages, and he still doesn't know how to take it right. Trust me. That's it. I got you.
Oh,
I mean,
shit.
With the kick.
That's what I'm saying. That's the way he did collapse during the sun. It was the kick.
He's not even in his fucking chair when he puts on when he gets in this fucking thing. He's not even in his fucking chair.
Yeah, but he there goes. Oh,
there he goes.
Both matches without the wrestlers were in the tape.
And on that note, everyone. It's your friendly neighborhood.
I stay loose, I stay hype. I stay loose, I stay hype. I stay loose, I stay hype. I could do this all night, cause I do what I like. Yeah, I do what I like. Yeah, I do what I like. Sipping goose, sip is right. And I go with the flow. Yeah, I go with the flow. Yeah, I go with the flow. Cause I know I'm the show. In the zone, here I go. In the zone, here I go. In the zone, here I go. Yeah, they know I'm a pro.
That you get elbowed in your elbow with an elbow. Got the arm ball, get the phone ball, get around with the bomb and the bomb ball.
That is gonna take you to
What up? It's fucking Thursday night, and you know what that means. Ray starting this bitch up muted.
Damn.
Yo,
okay.
Fucking mute yourself, Ray. I don't give a shit if
we're I made sure I was muted because I didn't know how well the intro was playing. I didn't know if it was gonna start me. Or if it was going to start me here from the get-go. So I was like,
it's going to start you everywhere.
So I was like,
you out, you in, you to the side, you to the other side. We everywhere, man.
I'm somewhere.
Yeah, fuck it. You always somewhere.
What's going on, bro?
Chilling like a villain on penicillin, man.
Hey.
I see you looking at my tank. I see you looking at my tank. I see where your eyes go. I don't know why the Instagram part isn't working. It says it on here that we're streaming, but
I don't know.
Well,
I thought I was checking the channels that we're on, and it says it's streaming.
Yeah.
So, but you know why it's not working. It says we're good. I don't know.
Yeah,
maybe,
man.
It takes a second to fucking.
Probably. But you know what? We live in living color on fucking YouTube. Twitch, Facebook, Kick, Spotify, OnlyFans, Apple Podcasts, wherever the fuck you want to be.
We somewhere.
Word. Yo, the God Killer Toe and the Father Figure Ray, let's go.
Yo, what's going on, Kenny, Mr. Loki?
Kenny is in the fucking building also.
Yo, what's going on, Kenny? What's up?
Shit, man. Yo, we out here, man. Yo, it's fucking Thursday night. We talking about wrestling. I'm going to explain to you what's up with my fish tank.
Yeah, what's up with the fish?
All right, yo, so I had, if you look on the floor over here, oh, you can't see it, but my decorations is on the floor.
All right.
Like this the white shit right here is the filter. There goes one of my decorations. You see the decoration?
Yeah.
It's on the floor. Because I looked up this morning, yesterday while I was doing the sports show with Hutch. Yeah. I looked at the fish and I'm like, why are there white spots all over my Cardinal Tetris?
All right.
And I'm like, this shit don't look normal. So I look at it, I say, all right, so most likely it's ick. So my fish, and it, you know, it spreads and shit like that. So this morning I bought some shit that's supposed to kill the ick in 24 hours or 48 hours or whatever the fuck the shit says. So I dosed my whole fucking tank with the shit. I took the filter out so that way it doesn't filter out any medicine. But yeah, so apparently I got them. This is why they say you got to quarantine up to 4 weeks, because they could show signs of shit at any point.
Gotcha.
So right now I'm dosing my tank for ick. Didn't even have these motherfuckers for a week yet. I'm going to blame that one on Wolf. Because he mentioned the tank last week and he jinxed me.
Damn. Wait, so are the fish okay? Or?
So far so good. They're eating. It's not like they're not changing any of their habits or anything like that. I know they said that it could kill them and all that, but They're still eating. They're eating a lot, so.
Okay, got you. No, I was worried. When I saw the lights were off, I'm like, fuck. How many fish funerals are we hosting today? Jeez. Like.
Yeah.
But, damn. That does show, though, how much of a fucking process it is to fucking maintain that shit. Because. Jesus.
Yeah, man. It is fucking crazy. Like, I'm looking up all these things and they're over here like, oh, this shit is the best medicine for. What's going on, Gigi? She figured it out, ladies and gentlemen.
No, wait, don't say things like that. I haven't. I'm breaking out like crazy here on top of that. I got this here, this there, this sun up there. This is a lot. This is what we call stress, ladies and gentlemen. I have no makeup on. There's filter button here. There's and everything is scripted.
Yes. Yeah. That's the Christmas font.
Yeah, it's the holiday font.
That's the holiday font?
Yeah.
Oh, how gay is that?
Right? It's funny because next to the holiday font, there's a little snowman that
But there's no snowman down, here.
And there's no snowman here. So what the fuck? They sold us.
Where's my snowman?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
Snowman? I was like, damn. I used that shit yesterday too with Hawkeye. Where? I was like,
Facebook Live, YouTube, Twitch, LinkedIn, add your channels. This is what. Now I see it.
And apparently, I'm not live on Instagram.
Yeah. Even though it says I'm live. Streaming, yeah.
Yeah, it says
you must have Instagram Live producer to unlock streaming.
Yeah.
Am I frozen? Y'all can still see me move side to side?
Yeah.
I don't know because I'm not even looking at you. I'm like looking at this.
Gotcha.
So you know what? Let's do a split screen.
Instagram Live?
It's one split screen here.
Is that enough?
Split this other screen over here. And let's figure out our lives, man. Yeah.
Word.
Where am I? Oh, I just minimized it.
Now I want to look that up because what the fuck?
I'm so like, ladies and gentlemen, this is what we have to figure out. All right, set up your live stream copy and paste and settings in your streaming software. I don't have a streaming software.
This is a streaming software.
Yeah,
we're using right now.
Streaming software, yeah.
Yeah. Yo, Gigi's giving me that face of like, you motherfucker.
You know what's the funny thing? I can't even find you guys, right? I'm trying to find you. Oh, I see it. Okay. Yeah, I think I see it.
Okay, what is this? Instagram live producer.
Yo, hold on.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, so it just gives you like the same stream key. Okay.
Create, click the create button, then live video from the drop down menu. If you don't have a professional Instagram account, you will not see this. Got it. Okay, so let's add this tab. Instagram. Oh man, do I want to do Instagram live with my face looking like wild like this right now? It's concerning. It's very concerning. No, let's not do that.
Okay. I don't know.
Create live video. Go live by connecting onto your choice of streaming software. Hey, to get started, add a title. What's the title? What should be the title? Wrestling with Knuckleheads? Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I mean,
Yeah, that's what we're doing. Fucking people.
So I got to this part and there's no live.
I can't see what you're doing because I have.
Oh well.
Wait, so you copied that stream key already, right, Tom?
Yeah, I put it in there.
Yeah.
I did not. I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet, man.
Like, why is it not working?
Because it doesn't like us, audience.
In the what?
Cancel. Okay. Oh, I have to choose an audience. Well, public. It's a public service announcement. Y'all can tell me what my face looks like because I don't even know. I'm not even like.
Oh wait, now it's sending data.
Now it's I recopied.
Okay, now it says
stream URL. Oh!
There you go. We're live.
Hey!
Now we're live on.
On whose?
On mine.
On yours?
Hey!
So where it says stream URL, should I just put the stream that's at the top?
Hey! How does this look though? On mine. Oh, this.
I'm trying to figure out if this.
At least I can see Gigi.
Okay. Oh!
Yes.
Look at how that looks.
Yeah, I don't know why that does that, but.
What does it
no,
do?
No, look how it looks. I
have to. Let me close this out.
All right, so let me see if we do. Oh,
this is how we look right now.
Yeah.
Oh.
So if we do this, does it change? Like, how does that look now?
Possibly. Hold on. Give it a sec to buffer. It's still on me. Hold on.
Technology.
No, now I can just see.
Technology.
All I see is me and Gigi. Now.
Why?
Listen, Ray. At this point, let's be real. They just need us.
This is true.
Sorry, Toe.
I mean,
Hold on. I'm trying to get this for us. Wait, on my thing too, because this is like beyond me.
And no, this is great. This is what.
This is pretty fucking cool.
Thank you, Restream, for now giving us the option to just...
Am I still live?
I believe so. Give me one second. Yes, you are still live.
How come I can't see it on...
I'm looking. I see right now. Let's see who's live on Instagram. You're live on Instagram. Casey Navarro is live on Instagram. Shout out to Casey Navarro.
How come I can't see myself? Oh, okay.
I'm seeing it. I'm looking at Instagram now.
Oh, all right. No, I had to go to my profile page.
So I need to copy this and then paste it here. Oh. Wow. I feel like a fucking idiot right now.
Hey, why am I not? I can't see my live on the phone.
Channel.
Wait, maybe because you are live, bro. So I don't think it's gonna let you open it.
Toggle on and off.
Okay, so I went to the knucklehead shit. Now I can see.
The title setup isn't supported with this platform. I mean, you got GG4.thewin.
Right. All right, let's see. Now, does it? Are you live?
I know. I said, oh, that's, I'm streaming. I'm streaming.
Oh, give it a second.
I see myself.
Oh,
I'm gonna hit the done button. Okay.
Oh.
Okay. We're getting somewhere. Hi, folks. Hi.
Hello, everybody.
We're experiencing some technical difficulties as we're trying to figure out this whole new Instagram live streaming cross platforms. You got me here, Gigi, for the win. You got Ray from Respect the Craft. When you got Toe, who I don't know if y'all can see, but we got Toe Tags in the building. This is Wrestling with Knuckleheads. This is us every Thursday night, 9 p.m. We might switch it to 8.
Is Gigi
not there yet?
I don't see Gigi live, though.
All right. Does it say go live on the top right corner of the Instagram thing?
I can't. Wait. Am I live?
I don't see you live.
Gigi just did a whole intro and she wasn't live.
Hey, yo, listen, you're live on mine, so you just did that for me. People only see you on
mine. Oh, we know it's live!
There you go.
Now do the intro, Gigi.
Yes, now I see you live.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Wrestling with Knuckleheads. We're figuring this shit out. Technology, bitch! Yeah!
Yo, I'm mad because like, people are not watching.
I'm as mad as my hair.
Let me see how. Okay, I gotta be like.
I see Gigi's live.
I gotta be like this.
Oh wait, this shit just went on my computer. It shows the whole thing if you watch it live on the computer.
All right, this is cool. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Wrestling with Knuckleheads.
I'd be like this so people can see me.
Girl, Gigi for the motherfucking win over here. We got Ray from Respect the Craft. And if y'all can see Toe, put your hand a little bit, put your head out. Close to
Ray. We got to look like we're about to reach to each other.
If you're on your phone and you can't see Toe, there he go. He's right there. We got this bitch.
Oh, man.
Technology, man.
A word.
Shit! How's everyone doing today? What's going on, everybody?
What's going on? Gina, what's up? Yo, for everybody that's on Instagram that's watching us, I would just like to give a holly jolly fuck you because this is the first time you're watching us and you deserve one. You deserve a fuck you.
This will be our first and probably last time we're on Instagram.
Yes, you deserve one.
Yo, just a holly jolly fuck you.
Y'all don't understand the amount of fucking shit we just went through right now just to figure out how to go ahead and work Instagram Live with the cross platform that is Restream right now.
No, this is great.
I'm ready to smoke. I don't have anything rolled up yet, but I am here. We're ready to talk about wrestling. We're going to go ahead and get this popping with my little 3 viewers that's on my page right now. 4.
Appreciate you. 4.
We're just going to keep doing this. We're just going to keep growing the page. Let us know what you guys think of any thoughts of anything that happened in pro wrestling this week. AEW, WWE. What?
I got to be like this to be on your Instagram. So does Ray. Ray, move to your right, Ray.
Nah, bro. Just see my shoulder. My shoulder's in it. My shoulder's in it.
Gigi is the social media ambassador anyway, so she deserves to be on the line.
I don't even know how I got here.
Hear our voices,
alone
did
I get this position, all right? This is insane. But I'm glad that this worked out. And if you guys... Wait, I don't even know what it looks like on the phone. How does it look like?
No, that's why we're saying we got to be like this. Because that's the only way you can see us on the phone.
Yeah.
They can see you, but they see us.
I'm going to look at Toe. I'm his only viewer. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, no, we can't see you guys. It's okay. I'm here. I'm here for you guys. Yeah, I don't need to see them. It's here. You can hear them. You don't need to see them.
Yeah,
okay.
This is true.
It's okay. Next. It's better for you not to. I promise you that.
Yes.
Okay.
I don't know what y'all talking about. Damn, they want to see at least look. Damn.
They want
to. No, but this is a cool option to go ahead and This motherfucker. This guy. Unbelievable. Oh, anyway, what's going on, fellas? We had a fun week in wrestling, I would say. CM Punk making his NXT debut. It's not really a debut. Yeah, it's just him showing his face there. He signs with Monday Night Raw, which is we kind of figured that was going to happen anyway, being that Randy Orton went to SmackDown. Nothing's really happening in AEW except for that tournament that they've been having, which not for nothing. What match was it? Briscoe versus Jay Lethal was fire.
Yeah.
Yo, Ray, do me a favor. Check Gigi's thing, because my shit came out backwards. I actually commented on your live, said we live, and it says it's backwards. It's evil with you, Eve.
Wait, hold on. Let me comment on shit came out
backwards. What? What is wrong? So, let's move over to the side, brother.
I don't know what the fuck is going on.
No, it says it. It says it there.
But look, all right. So look at yours. Look at mine.
Let me go to yours.
Look at mine.
No, looks like
me. You see, my shit came out back.
Evil.
Wait, why is it coming out backwards?
We don't know.
Hold on, let me try. We live.
No, we still live.
Is it coming out as we live? Is it
evil? Shit. My shit comes out backwards too.
Right? I had to write it back. This is the first time I ever wrote shit backwards. And I got it right.
Maybe on the computer. Play? What is going on?
I don't know.
What the fuck? We nip up?
Yeah.
Shout out to everybody that's hopping on for 2 seconds. Yes. We fucking appreciate you for hopping on for these two seconds of your life. We're so happy you were here with us. Yo,
because of Polter. What the fuck?
Oh, man.
Yo, for real.
Poltergeist? Oh, my God.
Poltergeist. That is hilarious.
Well, if you watch Instagram Live on your computer, you can see all of us.
Yes.
If you watch it on your phone, you see Gigi. So you're welcome, people watching it on the phone. You don't have to worry about me.
If you're definitely watching this on your phone and you got it from my page, thank you for coming to my page. I am... Ray, get your face out. It's not about you.
I didn't do anything. The fuck?
Get out of here, Ray.
If you have it on your PC or just your laptop in general, I'm so sorry for my friends. I want to go ahead and apologize in advance because they don't know what to do with themselves. Oh my God.
Yo, it comes out so nice on
screen. This is great. And I just lost all my viewers except for one. Thank you.
Damn, that was Ray's fault. That was Ray's fault.
That's all you guys.
My camera is off.
Oh, damn, you even got a cover for your camera now?
No, I'm sorry for my friends. It's all down here. It was. But yeah, I'm sorry for my friends, you guys. Oh man. That is wild.
I kind of want to see this in script. Word of the day. Yeah, ma.
Word of the day. Yeah, ma. That's right. Spell it with me. Y-E-M-A. Yeah, ma.
Is there all her views went back up?
Yeah, right? You see that?
Just the way she spelled Yemma. That was it.
We're at 200 now.
Oh, my God.
You can't give us shit. You can't give us shit.
Technology!
I'll tell you, at least Cosmic's shirt is being, advertised.
There you go. You get that.
You got to take off that Hulkamania up there, but that's okay.
No facts. Yeah.
It's something.
Yeah.
All right, so let's see. We have Friday Night SmackDown, right? And this was the SmackDown after Randy Orton went ahead and signed his contract with SmackDown with Nick Aldis. He had a fine to pay. he paid double that, and the reasoning why is because he's paying for an advance for when he does go ahead and RKO Nick Atlas again. Atlas? Aldis. Nick Aldis. I knew I was saying it wrong for a second.
Atlas sound right, though.
It does. It's not.
Yeah.
It's not. It definitely is Atlas. Not right. So we started off with that. We started off with SmackDown being SmackDown. Our tribal chief, Roman Reigns, will be in the building this coming SmackDown, where he will get, you know, possibly a confrontation between him and Randy Orton, which is going to be interesting. We're setting everything up. Oh, damn, right? That's how you feel? Damn. Hold up. Now I got to figure this out. Wait, I got to look. Oh, son of a bitch.
Right? He fucked it up for everybody.
So now I have to do the podcast like this.
Right?
Like, we have to do it on the side. Come on, we can make this happen. Did you just put us top and bottom?
I think so.
Pause. No, not like that. What are you doing?
I don't know.
What are you doing? That without the social media links.
Well, I can't put us like this.
Oh.
Without the social media. But you're still gonna have to go to the blue belt now.
I'm here.
She didn't go nowhere, folks.
I don't oh, there we go. You know, it's amazing because I'm watching myself on live, right? We're here. And then I'm watching myself as a delay on my Instagram.
it's a huge delay.
Massive. This is a massive delay. I don't even know how we're going to be able to do this, but we're making it happen. We're making it work. We're making small adjustments by moving left to right. You guys, yes, Lita is here. Oh, man. Shout out to all my cosplayers out there. You guys are awesome. Machoverse, Dusty, Triple H, Adam Cole, baby. Oh, man. Undertaker, you guys are all awesome. Keep it up. Keep up the great work. I'm so proud of you guys, especially the boys from Subway Mania. You guys are fucking killing it, and we really do appreciate each and every one of you. This is interesting. I'm like,
yeah.
I feel so far away, but yet so close, and I don't know what to do with myself. This is insane.
We are prioritizing this over every other form of streaming.
The thing, it's okay. Y'all can see the rest of my display. If
you there you go. Yeah.
Again. I don't know what's going on right now. And I'm gonna get to all your chats, all your questions, all your comments. Yo, what's up, Mr. Marvel 87? I see you. All right. I see you, Dusty. I see everybody on my live chat is dope, but I can't type because everything is typing backwards for me for some odd reason.
That is crazy.
And I don't know what the fuck. See, if I type in fuck, it types in fuck backwards. Oh, how about this? How about I type in KCUF? What? Backwards. Bitch. Fuck. Yeah. Are leveled. We're leveled. What does that mean? Does that mean that we're good? I don't know what that means. On my phone, it looks weird.
Yeah.
If you're on the phone watching Instagram Live, you're watching us, it just please let me know, how do we look? This is our first time doing this on the podcast. we're experimenting here, and we are very appreciative of your guys' feedbacks. We appreciate everything. Oh, man.
There is a mobile function, but I have to press it before we go live. But we would literally be like, the shit to the right and left of us would be black. We would be just for the phone. We wouldn't be like on YouTube and everything else. It would look weird.
Yeah.
No. The Brady Bunch.
Let's go.
Fucking Ray comes back ready to fuck shit up for everybody.
My bad. I got a phone call.
Oh, wait. So let me center myself back.
My bad.
I know what's going on. There we go.
We're back to normal.
In here.
Wait, I still got to be over
this
here.
This is great.
Oh, wait. So how the fuck do I got to be over? Wait, no. Hold on. Adjust the camera. Do it like this.
Thank you, Nelson, for letting us know that it looks good to you guys. Thank you. He's using his phone. He says it looks good.
So I got to go to the right. All right.
Well, Nelson, you mean it looks good because you just see Gigi or you see everybody?
I mean, if he sees just me, it's okay. He doesn't.
I mean, yeah, that's
that's
all
I got.
It's just me. It's on my
at this
page.
Point.
Okay.
At this point, matter. Just yeah. just hear our voices as well.
Yeah.
Listen
to our voice.
They're not even here for me. They're here for my collection. Let's be real, okay? They're not here for me. You see all these marks? I'm breaking out like crazy. They're not here for me.
That and the earrings. Right?
They're here for the collection. That's it. There's a lot. Yes.
That and the earrings.
Oh yeah, I love my earrings. Okay, so a lot again to trying to go back to wrestling. There's a lot to uncover. Move the body.
Right. I'm all the way the right I could be.
No,
a little bit more.
Right, move the body. Right.
You know what's crazy? I could just fucking do this. Right? Am I bugging?
Don't
Did
do that
change anything?
Don't do that. Because now I'm in fear for your camera falling off, and we don't need that. That's a lot of stress.
At this point, hold on. Let's do one of these.
Wait, okay. I went the wrong way.
Now. I was going to hold on the camera. Does that work?
All right, so now let's see.
Does this work?
Now you get to see the rest of my fucking room.
Now you just see the painting.
Yeah, now you see my face.
There's the painting. There's the painting in frame.
I just want to know when I'm typing, why is it coming out backwards?
Oh my God. This is.
Speaking of wrestling, WWE is stacked right now, coming from Gigi's IG.
My viewers. Yes.
So move your camera to the left, Ray. Like turn it to the left so that way you're more to the right. There you go. Now you have the lean.
Well,
beautiful.
I am now exiting out. I'm going to end this live video chat because I don't want nobody to just think that I'm out. I'll be right back, folks. Stay tuned.
Come to the YouTube channel. Fuck
this. Come to the YouTube channel.
You know
we're
going
to go back
to
this, but we're having too much fun with this. We'll be right back.
Yeah. I mean,
that needs to be our title.
Nobody's watching my shit anyway, so it's
all right. Download your video, view this in your archive. Okay. I'll do that in my archives. Discard live video. No, I don't want to discard it. I just want to. Well, go fuck yourself. All right. I'll be right back, gentlemen.
All good. All good.
Oh, shit. My mic.
Let's just do this so that way if she actually says something.
Gigi is no longer live. Should I just leave us live on Instagram or should I take it off too?
Whatever you want to do, bro. If you want to kill it. This is a nice test. I feel like they're still going to update it a bit just so it then runs smoother.
Yeah.
Just like Kick. It took a while for Kick to actually get integrated into this the right way. So I feel like it's going to be the same way Instagram.
All right. You know what? I ended the connection to it. So let's see. But anyway, but listen, we can do special shows just on Instagram Live. So like, let's say if big news happens, we could come on here. There's actually a function where I can go, like if we're going broadcasting to a phone.
And, we do it. There's a
So we could do that.
We have to select on it before we go fully live.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that. That works. That works.
So we got it to work.
Yeah.
And there you go.
Y'all gotta do the Brady Bunch boxes. The funny thing is, we technically could because there's hold on. When there's more of us, we can technically do that type of shit. But it's just there's gotta be more of us. Like We'll work. We'll make it work eventually. But we got it to work somewhat because we got to be on there at least. So whoever was on there, we appreciate you. But we live, baby. We live.
Shit, Gigi was actually trying to do some. Did I go back live?
Oh, are we live again? Are we?
I don't even know. I don't even know. To be honest with you, I feel like we haven't.
I don't know anymore. We might be live. We live. I thought we were live. Is this a simulation? What is happening right now?
I don't know how to unlive it.
Oh, shit.
Well, no, unliven. How did Gigi unliven?
I don't know. That did also sounds like the PG wave saying fucking kill. Unlive.
How did you kill the stream, Gigi?
Hold on. Oh my god. Why am I... Now all my cousins are messaging me.
Because we live. You know what? Fuck it, man. Yeah. We're talking about wrestling. What's up with this fucking... I know Gigi wanted to talk about Randy Orton being there. He paid the extra fine, so the next way he... Next time he...
I love my fucking... son just say, yo, here's $100,000. Just in case for the next time. Like, yo, if I had to pay a fine of $50,000... I'm never doing it next time. That's it. DK for the next one. Get the fuck out. What's I say, yo, just for the next one. Just end the live feed. No, sis, if we do that on here, that ends everything.
Yeah.
So we can't, we have to make sure we don't end the whole stream because then you guys can't see it.
All I did was I disconnected the connection to Instagram. So
we should be good. We should be good.
But it still says I'm live on the...
Let me see. Yeah, it still says we're live. Oh, shit. Fuck it.
But when I go to it, it's so... The live video has ended. Thank you for watching. Okay. And no, now we're no longer... All right, It takes 17 years to learn how to...
Got you. Just...
Yeah, nah, it takes 17 years for some shit to happen on Instagram. It's all right, though. You know what? Fuck, we out here. We learning, too.
Oh, I just noticed that Naya texted me showing me how we look to move to the right. My bad. I was on a call, too. Because everyone decides to call me while we're live. We're live, pal.
Move to the right. Not to the left. More right, stop being wrong. So,
all right. So Randy Orton is back.
Yes.
Randy decides to pay fucking 100,000 tenders.
No one realizes that we have a new background.
I did, but I just didn't want to say anything until you said something.
I was doing this last minute. I was trying to get some lights to go in the back here, but
yeah. Well, for everyone to see it, hold on, we're gonna. All right, we're in the Christmas spirit, folks.
Yeah,
the holiday spirit. Sorry, we can't say Christmas because
that's why you get a holly jolly fuck you.
Yeah, because apparently you can't say Christmas no more.
Word.
So a holiday spirit. We're in the holiday spirit. We are 11 days from one of the holidays.
One of them.
Yeah, I just spent a lot more money today for said holiday.
Oh, nice. And
my bank account is loving me right now.
I'm broke.
Basically, I was like, shit. The only thing I bought for myself today was some pancakes. Everything else was for everyone else.
Tomorrow I'm going to wake up and be like, I'm rich. And then I'm going to open my eyes. I'm broke again. I'm fucking broke again.
So I'm going to wake up and be like, yo, I'm rich, bitch. Wakes up from the dream. Fuck, I'm still broke.
It is worse. I hate you people.
Be like that fucking Chappelle Show skit. Yo, I'm rich, bitch. Wakes up, fuck, I'm still broke. Fuck. But nah, it's good though. It's the holidays. It's time to fucking spend time with some fam. Enjoy. Open some presents. It's a good time.
Word. Yeah. So... You know, wait until Gigi comes back. You gonna be when you want to do the Tone the Show tomorrow or Saturday?
I thought you had the party tomorrow.
See, he remembers shit.
So I thought we were doing it Saturday. I'm free either day, so it doesn't matter.
Just asking. You gotta have fucking take my head off, Ray.
No, I'm just trying to make sure it's good for you because finally I'm free either day. There's no shows this weekend. There's no last minute. Unfortunately, I can't be there. So if you want to do it tomorrow night. That works for me. If you want to do it Saturday night, that works for me. I could even do it Sunday night. I don't think that works for you, though, because you might be dead on Monday. So, the Tone the Show with Ray will actually feature Ray this week.
Right?
It might not feature Ray next week, though. depending on the day we do it. If we do it Friday, possibly. If we do it Saturday, I don't think I'm gonna be here. I'll be starting my Christmas weekend in Jersey.
See?
I'm back to New Jersey.
So everybody's going to Jersey all of a sudden. They think they're better than us.
That's where I go. That's how I leave. I get to take a break from the normal home life here, and I get to go to Jersey. Hey, yo. You're not supposed to put my business out there like that. I can't do that every night. I'm just saying. Can't put that out there for everyone to know.
Shit, somebody got to. Shit.
But,
yeah, so Randy Orton's on.
I'm trying to think what else we could talk about until DJ gets back.
Let's talk about the whole AEW is about to lose $34 million this year.
Okay, I saw that, but they also made, what, a good 70? Allegedly, 70 million? So it's like, any company right now is going to lose money. No matter what, companies are going to lose. But they're also, they're breaking even. They're finally getting paid to be on a network. It's not a pay-to-play scenario. Wembley sold out, so they made money there. Like, also, my thing is this. I love nowadays everyone cares about these numbers. I love how this is now being reported more than ever. Oh, these are the ticket sales, and these are the pay-per-view sales, and this is the demo sales, and this is this and that. And I'm like, is anyone making money from this outside of the companies that we're talking about? Because I feel like most people that are reporting this, it's like, yo, it sounds like you had money invested that are now reporting. Like, when I see Meltzer, when I see these guys reporting on it, I'm like, did y'all lose or make money because of this? Like, damn.
They're trying to get clickbait going.
And that's what it is. A lot of the time when I see that, I'm like, yo, the amount of clickbait articles. And I look at a lot of these. I try to start through the bullshit, because when I find out stuff before a lot of this post, and I'm just like, that's not how it works, but okay. And then I see stuff like that, and I'm like, okay, but again, are you making or losing money from this? If not, why report it? Why talk about this when it's like, I don't know. Like I said, to me, it's funny when they bring this up to show, oh, this is why WWE is better. This is why AEW is better. I'm like, yo, but both companies are thriving right now. Like, come on.
It's crazy because this is what I, because I just Googled it, because when you said it, I was like, oh, what's going on, Ruthless La La
in the building?
When you said that, I Googled it, because I was like, all right, let's get the nitty and the gritty. You know how I like the nitty and the gritty. Ad removed. No one asked you for shit. So I Googled it, and it goes, it has been estimated that AEW will generate an approximately $154 million in net revenue this year, up from $100 million in 2022.
That's not bad.
Yeah, but then you get another shit saying that they're estimated to lose $34 million. Now,
okay. Roughly, they're breaking even at a good, clean $75 million. Let's say.
Yeah. That.
They're breaking even with $75 million income in. Which is not bad for a fucking multi-million dollar company.
No, they...
Like...
No, the $120 million.
Like, shit.
Because if they generated $154 and they lost $34,
I'm trying to think of what they're actually...
Yeah.
All
right, so this is what... This is what the article says here.
Okay.
It has been estimated they'll generate $154 million up from blah, blah, blah. United States media right deal with Warner Brothers Discovery will bring in bulk of AEW's revenue, estimated to be around $68 million per year, to air Dynamite, Rampage, and Collision. With the current deal believed to expire in the end of 2024, AEW brings in additional revenue from international TV deals with the likes of ITV in the United Kingdom and Eurosport in India to generate a further $7.8 million. In total, WrestleNomics has estimated AEW will bring in $98 million for 2023, which includes an additional $19.4 million from pay-per-view buys. Another $34 million, meanwhile, will be generated from just over 500,000 ticket sales by the end of the year, along with a further $22 million in revenue from consumer products.
Okay, so by that breakdown, just take away their ticket sales, and they're breaking even with more than $100 million.
Okay, all right. So I think this is where it goes. He goes, the increased revenue is still lower than AEW's expenses. However, the talent compensation is estimated to cost around $85 million per year. Media and even media and event operations expenses add to another $66 million to outgoing, while consumer products, licensing expenses, and general expense brings AEW estimated outlay to just over $188 million. So they made $154 million, but they spent $188
million. Okay. Okay. You know what's crazy? When you look at how these numbers are into us, that's a lot of fucking money.
Yeah.
I would love to see the WWE breakdown. Because you know, these are probably nowhere near billion. Their expenses. Their expenses are close to half a fucking $1 billion. I can imagine. To put on their fucking shows. I can imagine.
Okay. In 2022, the World Wrestling Entertainment global revenue amounted to nearly $1.3 billion.
And their expense? Is that there?
No, that's the...
Because they're making one point something billion. You know they're spending at least a good $500 million.
Yeah.
Just for the pay-per-views and all that, and just for actual... Yeah. Bro, it's... But this is what I'm saying. We're not making a dime. We're not losing a dime from this.
I mean, I made $6 off of the you know, the stock markets for WWE, because you know I got $5 in there, so I'm up to $13. You know what I'm saying? I'm a rich motherfucking man now.
All right, bro, let me borrow a dollar.
I can't afford that.
What's that say? Yo, I made $13. Yo, let me get a dollar. Nah, man, I'm still broke. Yo.
Okay, hold up. If I'm reading this correctly, mm-hmm. revenue was $410 million, an increase of 25% and a quarterly record.
Okay.
Operating income was $87.3 million.
For a year.
This year? For the second quarter of 2023.
Oh, just for the second quarter. Okay, that's not bad.
I mean, if I'm not mistaken, then that means that they only spent $87 million, but they made $410 million?
Yeah, but that's for the second quarter. So that also doesn't show what they made in that first quarter. And that doesn't, that's still, just based off that, if they're doing equal amount, they're still spending less. The percentage is less.
Yeah.
That's not bad. That's not bad for WWE. That's not bad. So that is also something everyone would love to have a budget like that, to fucking be able to.
Yeah, but that's where I think Nick Khan comes in with all the business shit, and Vince McMahon with his shit on with Saudi. Because remember, you got to make more money than you spend. And otherwise, you're in a problem. Yeah, otherwise you're in a problem.
And that's what they do well, because Nick Khan is a business. That's something I feel like, this is why I say, you have to still have someone that knows business, but they can't be the one running the wrestling operation. Like, they can't be the booker. They could be the one running the finance. You need that. But you still need someone as the booker that knows wrestling.
Yeah. I'll be the booker. We get Skinner back in this motherfucker.
My son says Skinner. So why did I see someone mention Hillbilly Jim earlier on my social? I was like, yo, what are these names now? I don't think any of these guys can still wrestle right now.
Wait, Hillbilly Jim to wrestle?
Yeah, I was like, who the fuck is trying to book Hillbilly Jim?
I mean, you should. Isn't he dead?
I don't think so. I'm gonna look that up. Hold on. I don't think he is. He might be, but I don't think he is. Our apologies, folks. This is what we have to do right now to No. Oh shit, he did die. Jesus.
He did?
In 2015. Whoops. Rest in peace, Hillbilly Jim.
Wait, he died in 2015?
That's what it says here.
Why does it say Hillbilly Jim in March 2020?
I'm looking at this. It says December 20. Oh, no, hold on.
On Wikipedia, he's 71 years old. But that's...
Hold on. Born. Da, 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 da. No, it says he's 71. Why does one article say he's dead? Wikipedia says he's still alive. Someone let us know, is Hillbilly Jim still alive?
Right?
No, apparently they just tried. Oh, no, I think he's good. Because apparently he just signed a new Legends deal. So he's good.
Oh, wait, he's dead because he signed a new Legends deal? No.
He's good. He's good.
Oh.
He just signed a new Legends deal in October. So apparently, Hillbilly Jim is still alive and kicking.
Yo, do you remember the good old days when if you put in a question to Google, Google said yes or no?
Yeah, now it's like you'll get three answers. And it's like, you figure out which one you think is right.
Yeah, it's like, do you want him to be dead? Because they got an article that says he's dead. Do you want him to be alive? We got an article that says he's alive. Like, the fuck, man?
Just tell me, is he alive or is he dead?
I don't want to play these games. I'm broke.
Someone in the chat, please confirm. What do you think? Because we don't know anymore. Like...
Fucking ridiculous, bro.
Yo. that's going to be the first question we ask Gigi. Let's see what she thinks when she gets back on. Gigi, do you think Hillbilly Jim is alive?
What, right? She's probably listening like, yo, I'm not getting back on. Fuck these niggas.
She's like, that's it. I did my appearance. I can't get fined anymore. I showed up. That's what we're here, folks, just so we don't get fined. Who's fining us? We don't know, but someone's going to give us a fine if we don't show up.
Word.
Word. I got fine because I wasn't here on Saturday for the show with Ray.
Yeah. I took double his fucking check.
I'm not getting money. Paid double though. That's crazy.
I took double his show money.
Damn.
For the next time, this motherfucker.
Yo, when he saw I got paid for doing wrestling, he was like, "Nah, that's it."
Where
he his pay?
You think you're better than us? But yo, man. This definitely turned into a battle between AEW and WWE once CM Punk came. It's feeling like that even more so, especially on social media.
So this is where I put it to you. Do you feel like, again, is it an actual battle between the companies or are the fans making it that way?
The fans are making it that way.
I feel like right now, for Tony Khan, this is competition.
Yeah.
Even though for WWE, it still isn't. For WWE right now, signing CM Punk right now, even though it's a great move, we all called that it was going to happen, was just out of because I can.
Yo, let's face it. Tony Khan takes shit personal, and Triple H said, let's poke the bear.
Let's poke the bear. Like, yo, just because they could. And it's a great power move. It's like, yo, come on. Like, you know you want that Mania match. You can come home. You can say, fuck you, Tony Khan. And you show up.
Yeah.
And again, it got the best reaction ever. A lot of the WWE fan base does not know what just happened a few months ago. Don't know about all the brawling or whatever they called it. Don't know about fucking Jungle Boy wanting to use real glass. Don't know about the Young Bucks fucking having a fight in the locker room. None of that. So they're just enjoying that CM Punk's back. The other half of the WWE locker room, our fan base, knows what happened. And they're just like, yo, we got CM Punk back. So cool. Let's see how long he lasts.
Yeah.
But that's the thing. Because of that, it's still getting a reaction. The worst part that could have happened is CM Punk got nothing. It's just like, oh, he's back. No, got a pop. He got the best promo ever from that fucking fan. Fucking Chicago. Yo, that fan could have said anything because hard cam was right on him. And fucking Chicago. Oh, I give it 3 months. Nah, it has to be at least till Mania. He wants to make it till Mania. I'll be 4 months away.
Because it's in April, right?
Yeah.
Fucking hate it.
So
that used to be on my birth month, but then Jared Diaz fucked around, and these motherfuckers do it in the beginning of April.
Yep, gotta do it in April, man. Count this month. It's almost okay. So Technically 3 months. Okay, okay. By my standards, we're going 3 months. But still, he'll be there till April. But even then, I feel like because he's going to win the title, he'll still be there a little longer. So, I know. You don't want to win the title, but it's going to happen. It could have been the Roman title, but at least I think we're going the right way. Because I was having that conversation with my boy, and I'm like, I could see it. I could see them want to do Punk and Roman for the money match. But you book that, you're booking yourself into a corner. Because then it's like, if he beats Punk, then who really is left?
Yeah.
So and you know, have to keep them away from each other.
To be honest with you, I kind of see Roman Reigns sitting this WrestleMania out. There's no contender. There's no one worthy. Winning the Royal Rumble ain't mean shit.
Bro, he can't. He has to lose that belt this year. He has to. Because, bro, if he holds it another year of barely title defenses, you're just stacking the number.
He got about 2 to 3 more matches with Brock Lesnar in him. Oh, that's 2024 right there, booked. I'm telling you.
Oh, man. It has to be. As I see it right now, Mania is this. Punk and Seth. Usos battle it out. LA Knight versus Randy. Logan Paul has to defend that U.S. title against somebody. Roman Cody 2. Electric Boogaloo. I'm still trying to decide who wrestles for the tag titles.
But I don't think we're going to have them by then.
By then, they have to kind of... I feel like they have to split the titles. Like, we need multiple tag team champions instead of just, here's your undisputed title set. We need Raw titles, SmackDown titles.
That would constitute Raw and SmackDown having tag teams.
I feel like they do, though. I think you have enough if you actually have tag teams. Like, you actually, instead of just doing 6-man tags, there's enough. You have the street on SmackDown alone, you have a decent amount of teams if you start using them as teams. This is where you can start calling some people up too from NXT. They're just sitting there. Because we know Humberto Carrillo and Angel Garza are coming up eventually now to be with Santos. That's another team. You can use that. You have tag teams there. Raw, we saw it a week ago with the tag team Battle Royal. There's enough tag teams there. So I could use that for a Raw tag team division. But it's just figuring out how to split them. And with the Judgment Day right now, I don't think you can split them because they have fucking R-Truth.
Yeah, R-Truth is the Sami Zayn of the Judgment Day.
Yeah, but they have to lose those titles before Mania because I do see that being a match. I do see Finn versus Damian being a match at Mania. I see that being a match. Logan versus someone, Randy versus LA Knight. I really wanted to see Gunther versus Seth, but now we might.
Oh, Gunther.
Because of how they're booking this, we might see fucking. I wouldn't be surprised Ludwig versus Gunther at fucking Mania.
Yo, Bad Blood is sitting here going, Miz is winning the title because they put stipulation on it. So yeah, it might be the Miz versus Gunther at WrestleMania.
But doesn't Miz have to win now at the Rumble? Or do you hold it off till Mania? Do a fuck finish at Rumble. And you somehow you extend this all the way to Mania. Because I do see Miz winning that title.
I mean, shit, why not?
I wouldn't be mad at that if Miz is the one to dethrone him. Just because, shit, give the Miz something. This is the guy that when in doubt, they're able to shuffle him in and he fucking does what he needs to do.
Yeah, when in doubt, whip Miz out.
He has done a good job, like fucking the first match with Bad Bunny, made it work. The tag match with Logan Paul made it work. Like, he knows his job.
And the WrestleMania spot with Shane McMahon. Bro. And it turned into Snoop Dogg. Made it work.
Yo. That's what we need to see this year at WrestleMania. Run it back.
Snoop Dogg versus The Miz.
Yep. There you go.
For the Intercontinental title at WrestleMania.
There we go.
You're welcome.
There we go. Special guest enforcer, Shane McMahon.
Yes. He's
not going to get in the ring just so he doesn't tear his quads, but Shane McMahon is going to be there.
Shit, man. I know we're probably going to have to bring this back up, but do you think with CM Punk coming really fucked up the plans for pushing other superstars? Like, I honestly think the best thing you could have did was push Jay.
Like, no, I think the plan all along still had to be Jay versus Jimmy eventually.
Yeah, but they're really toning the fuck Jay down with him losing clean to Seth for the title, then him losing twice to Drew McIntyre, and it's almost like he can't even hang with Drew.
Yeah, but it the match with Seth, it didn't look like, oh, he didn't even have a chance, you know? Like, that match with Seth, we saw something. We still saw that this guy could be a world champion.
I don't know. Well, not against Drew.
No, but that's the thing. Drew ain't winning either. We're seeing Drew get another title shot, and that's the thing with Drew is that this match at the Rumble, if it happens, it's burying the lead on Drew. Because how many times does Drew need a title shot for them to finally be like, okay, now back of the line? Because that's how it ruined Shinsuke. With Shinsuke, it was like, yeah, another title shot, and then another title shot. It's like, okay, you're going to fucking finally let him win the title. No, back to the line. Like, wait, what?
That's what ruined Drew the first time with Bobby Lashley.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that with Jay, at least, he had his title shot. He was right there. And then you do the fuckery with Drew. And it's like, okay, that saves him. Because now it's not like, oh, I almost had you. Give me one more shot.
See, but he should have never had that title shot at that point. Because I honestly think Jay should have been built up to Gunther, because Gunther would make him look strong, and then you can have Jimmy fuck up Jay, and then you could have bring in The Miz doing this shit, because right now it's like, what's The Miz is for Royal Rumble, and then what you gonna do with Gunther at WrestleMania? You can't have Gunther fight for the world title or Roman Reigns because CM Punk is back, and Cody Rhodes he's still got pages left in his story.
And that's the only thing. I will say this. Punk now, it doesn't ruin plans, but it does add a wrench to, well, now we know what we could do for Mania instead of this. But it also...
It's not as bad, but he's doing to these prospects, to main event WrestleMania, what The Rock did to him when The Rock took the world title from and for John Cena at WrestleMania.
Yeah, it definitely is. But the problem, the thing is, now Punk knows it's a business. It's not just because all these guys have learned it. Zayn even said it when he said it about the interview after doing this run like The Rock does. It's like, you know what? Now I get why he couldn't come back and have a full run. He understands it. Just like with Punk. Punk knows, hey, I'm now the attraction. They're going to put me in Mania. Unfortunately, that takes a spot from a guy that's been here. The problem is, it makes sense. It makes sense to do Seth and Punk. It's going to be money. It's a money match.
It makes sense, but the issue is, I'm seeing it as CM Punk's coming from the pit and cutting everyone off on the track. Yeah. But when you come from the pit on the track, it still moves seamlessly. You find your spot. Him, everyone has the slow, like, everyone hit the brakes. You know what I'm saying?
No, yeah. I get that. It's, like I said, it sucks because, let me say it in this frame. From the fan perspective, it's like, fuck. We knew, like I said, the amount of matches we talked about a few weeks ago. I thought for the longest, we could finally see Gunther versus Seth, possibly do the Warrior thing. A fucking Gunther wins both and then drops the IC, so that way you don't have to have him lose the IC title.
Yeah.
Remains as a fucking great reign and then wins the world title. And then you build a star. Or you could have finally had Gunther versus Roman. Finally. Somehow Gunther wins the Rumble, does that. That would have been an awesome match too. But with Punk, it's like, okay, now the lines are clear. I still think if they want to do something fucking crazy, because I talked about this over the weekend with my boys, and I was like, you know what? I wouldn't mind it. The fucking Brett and Luger finish. Woo-hoo. Having the double with Punk and Cody. Just so you kind of do something again, where now we get both ends and we know where the stories are going. Just to do something, just so that way it's like, wait, so how do we get these two stories to happen? Because technically, right now, there's no way to get fucking Cody to smack it.
To be honest with you, I would rather see Cody Rhodes and CM Punk versus Seth Rollins than Seth Rollins versus CM Punk. There's more of a story there because Cody's the only person to beat Seth Rollins.
Okay.
If you think about it, he's the only one. Right after he lost to Cody Rhodes, he became the champion. Yeah. So the last person to beat Seth Rollins was Cody. And CM Punk has beef with Seth Rollins. You know what I'm saying? So if let's say Gunther wins the title, yeah. Wins the Rumble. Because that's how I would do it. If you really want Gunther to go after the championship, have him throw over CM Punk. Have him do the swerve shit and let him win the Royal Rumble. No one expected. Let him go after Roman Reigns. And then you have the Elimination Chamber and you figure out a way to have a three-way dance between Seth Rollins, CM Punk, and Cody Rhodes at WrestleMania. They have their main events. They both have their stories, and it also... You're able to continue that shit after Mania with any pair that you want. And then Gunther and the Imperium are going with the Bloodline. And you can have Jay with Jimmy at WrestleMania also.
Okay. So this is how you book it. Royal Rumble. Final three. You have your Punk. You have your Cody. You have your Gunther.
And don't forget R-Truth.
R-Truth's going to be in there because R-Truth's going to be in there. R-Truth's going to grab a ladder. Truth is not a ladder match. Oh, my bad. Jumped over the top rope. We now don't have R-Truth.
He's going to climb the cage. Final three. There you go.
Down to the final three. We now have all three of them battling. Boom, 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 boom. CM Punk gets thrown out by Gunther. It's like, holy shit. You get the pop for Gunther. It's like, yo, this is truly one of those guys. Now it's like, okay, Cody's going to win, of course, because why not? Cody again. He did it the year before. Cody tries, does it again. Boom. Gunther is able to eliminate Cody. It's like, wait, his story. What the fuck happens now? Gunther chooses Roman. Because the Ring General wants to be the one to defeat the tribal chief.
Longest reign versus longest reign.
Yeah, so now you do that. That sets up Mania main event one. Elimination Chamber, you have... Fucking whoever's in there to determine who's going to face Seth. You have four other guys. You have Punk and Cody. Punk wins. But now Cody's like, how do I finish my story if I'm not even on the show? You build to that. You build to that. To him fucking pleading with Pierce, pleading with Aldis, whatever. You get to Punk and him having one more match. And you have the, because we know Raw can do it sometimes, a fuck finish of, you know what? Seth come out, be the fighting champion he is. You do the three-way dance. He says, you know what? I'll fight you both at Mania. So Mania main event one is that three-way Sunday main event, Roman versus Gunther. That's if you want to build a new star and still give us the money match. That would be a nice way to do it. What's probably going to happen? Probably not that, unfortunately.
Nah.
But that would be a nice way to do it.
Yeah. It's probably going to be the way that everybody wants him to do it because, you know, hey, listen to the fans.
My only problem is because of this, now you leave out so many vital players from last year's WrestleMania. Because now you can't, what do you do with Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn? There's no spot for them. There's no spot for them.
Unless you have, what the fuck is this guy's name? Gerard Lucas, Logan Paul.
Yeah.
Versus Kevin Owens for the United States title.
Okay. What do you do with Sammy? No Sammy on the card?
Sammy versus Rhea Ripley.
First time ever. Intergender WrestleMania in the modern day era.
Yes.
That's the other thing. Do we see Jade finally debut at the Rumble? Because I still say yes. I say that's where they finally debut her. And as much as it shouldn't happen that way, Jade wins the Rumble and then faces Rhea. Because they legit have built no one else.
I like the idea of fucking people over at the Rumble.
Okay.
So I like the idea of having Jade is gonna win this and Raquel Gonzalez wins the Royal Rumble.
I would not mind that.
I love the idea of that because the Royal Rumble, anything is supposed to happen.
Yeah.
And we no longer get anything supposed to happen. We get this is supposed to happen.
Yeah. I don't mind that though, because we should not. It's the Royal Rumble is supposed to be the one match that truly is expect the unexpected. The problem is we are going to get what you just said. They are going to be like, no, this is the fuckery you're going to get. Because I hope it happens. I hope we get the fucking AJ Lee entrance in it. But then people are going to think, oh, shit. She's in the final four. And then I guess she gets tossed out. Because that's what they would do. Just give us a little bit of hope. Be like, AJ's about to win the Rumble. Nope, she's gone.
Charmella eliminated
her. I see Carmella coming back because I think by now she should be good. She's had the baby, what, 4 months?
Yeah, that baby's about to go to college.
She should be good. But no, I think that's going to be the way they go, which I still think it's too soon to give her a Mania and title match, but we'll see. What's going on, Leon?
But the best part of waking up is the Royal Rumble setting up your WrestleMania stories, man.
It's supposed to be ending your stories. That's the thing people forget, too. It shouldn't be starting everything. And I feel like nowadays, WrestleMania starts everything.
Yeah, but Royal Rumble started WrestleMania 6. That whole thing with the Ultimate Warrior and Hulk Hogan facing each other in the Rumble and then Hogan eliminating the Warrior. You know what I'm saying? Like, that was where we got WrestleMania 6 from. And, you know, the champion gets his title shot at Red Rumble. But right now, there is no real heated storyline that you can finish at WrestleMania unless you end the groups, which I am not a fan of.
Yeah.
I've never been a fan of, the Judgment Day has been hot all year and now we need to end it at WrestleMania because we need them to split up. No, we don't need them to split. We didn't need the Bloodline to split up. Jay could have been running wrong.
That definitely doesn't end till after Mania, at least the Bloodline. Because Roman has to lose those titles in order for the Bloodline to fully be split up.
Yo, Damian Priest needs to win the championship. And because I like Nia saying you have them and he cashes in at WrestleMania. Beautiful. Because that's the fuckery. I would not mind it. CM Punk wins the title. And there goes Damian Priest. And Damian Priest is champion. And Booyaka Chad.
You know what I'm saying? You want to make Damian Priest the heel? You don't have him cashing on Punk. You have the story supposedly finally end. Cody Rhodes wins the titles.
You know why?
And then gets cashed in.
You know why I say CM Punk and not Cody?
Why?
Because Cody Rhodes and Seth Rollins are unbeatable.
No, but that's
no,
why
they can't. They can't lose. No, no. You can cash it in on them. Yeah. But then you make, effectively, once Damian Priest beats Cody Rhodes,
yeah.
1, 2, 3, WrestleMania, cashes in the Money in the Bank. He becomes the world champion. You have effectively made him the Big Show of world champions. You have made him the Patsy of world champions. He is the most transitional champion in the history of champions. His run will mean less than Andre the Giant's. Yo, The Miz would have a better run than Damian Priest with that title if he cashes it on Cody. Why? Because Cody and Seth Rollins are fucking Godzilla. They fucking heal rapidly. They don't fucking lose. CM Punk at least. CM Punk at least he does not have that mystique yet. Cody Rhodes and Seth Rollins are undefeated.
Yeah.
In their entire career. They relinquished titles. They didn't lose them. They relinquished titles.
Yeah. The reason I still feel like I see what you're saying, and I agree. The thing is, if you really, again, want to get him that heat, want to get him that, no, fuck you, I am the leader of the Judgment Day. Because what you do is you have Finn fucking win. Finn beats Damian Priest, and it's like, well, fuck it. This dude, he's not going to win a title. He's going to fucking cash in and lose. And then he sticks it to everyone and fucking beats Cody. Cody finally has that moment. You have the fucking confetti. You have him fucking put the title up for Dusty. Fucking have the... You got to do that entrance that fucking everyone was editing on TikTok. The fucking start with the American Dream theme.
Yeah.
And then transition into the fucking American Nightmare. That would be awesome. Fucking have everyone tearing up before Mania. But you do that. All that happens. Cody wins. And you have fucking Priest cash. Bro.
That would work. That would work if people gave a shit about Cody.
But in that moment, you do. Even if you don't after. Even if you don't before. That moment, you do. Because no fan is going to not enjoy seeing. You know what? This story thing is annoying. But seeing him do it. You're going to be in the moment. There's not one fan. Jim Cornette is going to, even in that moment, if he doesn't admit it, is going to be like, you know what? Fuck, they made me buy this story.
Yeah, yo, you see, for that one moment, for the fucking 7 minutes that's going to happen, it's going to be the greatest thing we ever saw.
But that's what you need.
But after that 7 minutes, it's going to be the worst thing we're ever going to see in wrestling. The Cody Rhodes coming out with his promo is going to be horrible. Damian Priest coming out wrestling on a little, I beat Cody Rhodes. Horrible. The match between Damian Priest and Cody Rhodes for the title is going to be horrible. You're going to see Seth Rollins talking shit. Horrible. And then where's CM Punk at? At least when CM Punk wins it and loses it, everyone be like, oh, he won the title. And he loses it to CM. We have something to build up because people are going to hate Damian Priest because you took the title away from my hero, my guy that's been gone for so long, the CM Punk dude, and not just some guy that's resting on his fucking lineage to grab attention from people. Because in all honesty, Seth Rollins and Cody Rhodes right now are just... fucking whoa, and they're just noises.
Yeah,
they're just noises that people like to make. You know what I'm saying? Like the way I see it, it's like that's the CM Punk is not the end all be all, but it's a feud I'm willing to swallow for Damian Priest's first run because automatically he's gonna lose that fucking title in that first defense.
Either way, he's losing the title, but. What? Okay, I get you're getting the after, but what is the bigger moment?
CM Punk.
No. Really think about this. For Mania, when we're talking about the reactions, right now, Cody versus Roman, is it predictable that Cody's going to win?
Yeah.
Is it?
You put Cody in there with anyone, Cody's winning.
We did it this year. Cody lost.
That was this year.
Based on the two badges, actually predicted?
I say this year he's winning no matter what because, one, everybody's tired of Roman Reigns wrestling every week for that title and defending the title. And people are they want to see him beat Seth Rollins because Seth Rollins did nothing with his title.
Yeah. The thing is, we thought Nakamura was finally going to win.
The difference between Cody Rhodes and Nakamura is the race. The race and the time. Think about it. If Cody Rhodes does not win at Mania and keep that title, no one will be invested anymore. Now, if he loses to CM Punk and he gets cashed in on, there's a way to save it. But he cannot win the Royal Rumble. He cannot win that shit at WrestleMania. You know what I'm saying? It's because this is the same shit that we had when Roman Reigns won the Rumble back to back. He needed to win it last year, and everybody got tired of the shit. His time to win the title was last year, Cody Rhodes. If you're gonna give him an exceptional way to win the title this year, he has to stay with it. He has to move on and defend that shit. And then Damian Priest is gonna have to cash that shit on at another time or somewhere else because he can't cash that shit in right after Cody Rhodes wins that shit. Because I am not gonna give a fuck about Cody Rhodes chasing that title again.
No. That's the thing. He can't. That's the end of the story. He won. He won the title. He got his moment. But that's what I'm saying. We will be talking about the fuck just happened. That'll be us on that Monday. Like, wait, what the fuck just happened? Time reading was because shit on the record. He has been. Well, yeah, because Roman has beat most of the records right now. No matter what, again, monumental title reign. But that moment of Cody just ended that reign. And then he finally ends his story. He gets the story. He does all this. And his title reign, his story is burnt like that. It's over. Again, a win over Punk also helps him. Because by then, I would assume Punk is still on an undefeated streak too. Because we don't know what else Punk is going to do. Because Punk is wrestling, at the holiday show at MSG?
Yeah.
That's the only confirmed match.
An adult collar match. Cody's wrestling in the dog. Cody's
wrestling in the dog out of it too.
Which is what on a house show?
Hey, it's MSG. I get it. They do crazier shit in MSG, which is funny because the commission's gonna love that. So it's either way, it's a Damian finally gets something. Either way, he's losing the title, unfortunately. This isn't a long reign, no matter which way he goes.
Because he looks weak. Let's be serious.
Yeah.
He looks weak.
But that's why I'm trying to find the way where now you're able to build something. The problem is, either way, they have not made us care. R-Truth punked them out. The only reason they were able to do something is because it was 5-on-1.
The reason why R-Truth punked them out is because they lost at War Games.
Well, again, that was also known. Randy's back.
Yeah.
You had the super team.
You're putting them in a no-win situation.
Yeah.
Because to be honest with you, this is the way it's going to go.
Yeah.
Cody Rhodes is going to win the title at WrestleMania. Damian Priest is going to come down. Damian Priest is going to lose that Money in the Bank shot match. And Cody Rhodes is going to beat him. And he's going to lose. And then Damian Priest is going to be mad at Raw. And he's going to get kicked out. And he's going to turn into fucking Sad Corbin.
You know what I would actually love to see? If, again, I'm almost right. Cody gets the moment. We now think, okay, cool. This is how this ends WrestleMania. The nice fucking storybook ending. Damian comes out. Quote unquote, cashes in. They ring the bell. Damian hits his finish. One, two. Wait. Check the briefcase. There's no contract in that briefcase. Remember, I still think they're going to play that. Because they gave him a new briefcase. They switched it out. I think they might do that just to fuck with us even more.
What? And R-Truth got the contract? No.
Finn has the contract.
Finn has the contract.
Now, give it to R-Truth.
That would be even funnier, though.
Yo.
If that ends with R-Truth somehow getting a title reign.
R-Truth has it in his lunchbox as senior money in the bank. Yep.
I would not be mad if R-Truth is the next champion.
I wouldn't live on Instagram. That's too much.
I would not mind it. I would not mind it at all.
Yeah.
Fucking, that's it. That's, but, again, the greatest return at Survivor Series was R-Truth. Give us an R-Truth title reign.
But with that, if you're going to do that with Finn,
yeah,
and you really need Finn and what's it, Andrew McAllister, whatever the fuck that guy's name is,
Matthew McConaughey. Jaden McDonough.
You need him and this guy to leave the Judgment Day and start his own crew, the club again or some shit.
Because he doesn't have enough on that would be, his name to do that right now.
But I mean that would be a fuck you to Rhea and Dominic. Yeah. And Damian Priest.
Yeah. You kind of have to. You have to do something where it's like, that is the power play. Finn Balor is the prince for a reason. He isn't just fucking, he isn't no one's second in command. He is the leader. So I wouldn't mind that.
And then you have like the whole New Japan Pro Wrestling shit. It was like Finn, AJ, the Good Brothers, Nakamura.
Who is AJ? He's not injured.
Andrew McAllister, fucking we're renaming this motherfucker. He doesn't matter. And
signing for the Diamond Wrestling.
Yes. And Andrew McAllister's in Diamond Wrestling. And who's this guy that's in NXT that was the NXT champion? Now he's going for the United States title. I think of Swerve in my head. For some reason, I'm
Swerving. Wesley. And
Carmelo Hayes.
Oh,
Carmelo Hayes be the color in that group.
Oh, my.
Yo, now that we're talking about Carmelo Hayes, let's go from Damian Priest really quickly to Carmelo Hayes. What is this bullshit that he's trying to sell us that everybody else was the ones that went ahead and attacked Trick Williams? When knowing damn well he was probably the one that fucking did it.
Because the devil has to make sure we don't know it's him.
They're playing a game of Among Us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like he legit.
I love that was something he tweeted when AEW put out the devil t-shirt. the mask devil. He's like, can I have one of those?
It's him.
Can I have one of those, please? And but no, it's great. Like they had this whole match with Lexus King at Deadline. And he's like, even Lexus is like, hey, it wasn't me, but thanks for the match. Like, wait, so you two fought for nothing?
Right.
Fuck was the point? And now he's going to SmackDown, where we'll probably see Trick Williams cost him his match on SmackDown. And then they'll finally wrestle on the next day.
I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm a little out of it and tired. Mom mode just kicked my ass. I just did 40 minutes of combing through matted hair.
And by that, she means...
Yo. I feel bad for the kid because, you know, she cried and shit like that. But I'm just like, yo, take care of your fucking hair. If you take care of it, we wouldn't be here. Guess what? Now we're here. When I tell you that shit's matted, that shit's like all of this, like... It hurts my skull. You don't say.
Yeah, I know that.
My arm hurts me. It just wants to do. It's just been doing this for the last 40 minutes. Jesus. I need some fresh greenery in my system. I haven't listened to you guys because if I listen to you guys, I can't listen to you guys.
It's all good.
Um,
Oh, wait, we forgot to ask our question. Gigi, even though you're dead right now, but it's all good. Hillbilly Jim, is he alive or dead?
Hillbilly Jim?
Yes.
He's alive.
Okay.
Google doesn't know.
Google doesn't. Google gave us two articles. One which he died in 2015. One that he's alive and well and just signed a Legends deal with WWE. Yep.
Please hold.
Dude, Gigi's like, you motherfuckers don't know how to Google.
Yeah. No, because we legit, I don't know what it was. Toast brought
Billy Jim, the yes. big guy.
Yeah.
He's still alive. No,
he's alive. We confirmed he's alive. But
like his Instagram is still up and running,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. We just looked it up because for some reason we just want to see what Google tells us. And Google brought up two articles. One that he was dead in 2015.
You should and have one that he just see. If y'all really wanted to know fucking answers, all right?
AI is not going to know this shit either.
I don't know how do we get
to AI would know it. All right.
What is it? Chap ATB?
Chat GPT. ABC 123.
ABT? EBT?
Yeah, BT.
CMT?
Chat Open Nana? Wait, I got to sign in for this?
Oh, geez. Just forget it. It's okay.
Open AI. Introduce. What? I want to talk to someone.
Have you never used ChatGPT?
No, I don't know who's the GPT is.
This nigga. This could be possibly your best friend or your only friend, but you have us as well because, you know, we signed the contract.
Log in. Why am I logging into something? I want to talk to people. See, this is why I don't do this shit. At the top of TBT, can eat my dick.
you know what's funny? Nah, you could type that in there and it would reply the way it would eat your dick. That's the sad part. You could legit eat my dick.
All I want to do
this is the way I would consume said dick.
Legit. Are you still live, by the way, on a fucking Instagram?
No. When you got off, I tried to figure out how to do it. And who was here like 10 minutes? Like, am I off? Wait, I'm still live. Why am I still live?
Let's get this right. You sent me the instructions in the group chat on how to do this.
Remember,
you sent me the fucking instructions.
Gigi, remember, he only got on like a minute before you did.
Yeah.
So he didn't know how to get on properly either.
I hooked my shit up and it wasn't live. And then I was like, oh, I got to do shit over here. And now I'm live.
You know what? You guys are going to get to watch me struggle do this next Tuesday on my next podcast.
I'll
be live next Tuesday, 7 p.m. I just confirmed my guest today. So next week. That's the time I confirmed you.
Yo, Ray be posting up his fucking interviews. And I'm just like, oh, shit, that's happening in like 5 minutes ago. What? What am I missing?
Yeah, for the past 3 weeks, I'm like, yo, when the fuck is this guy going live with his 200 episode?
I did it yesterday.
And then yesterday, I'm like, there it fucking goes. And I don't see no link to us to join. He said, you guys can jump on our 200 episodes and we'll celebrate. And no link.
Well, you know what's wild is that Ray didn't even ask us to give a shout out for his 200 episode.
Nope.
Send him a video or anything like that. So I want to let you know what a good friend is, Raymond. Okay. A good friend is a friend like Nick from High Side of the Ropes, who personally contacted me to go ahead and do two nominees of Best Female of the Year and Best Indie Female of the Year. Okay, and I did a voiceover. And on top of that, my other good friend, Purple's Best Wishes, Mr. fucking Ronnie Bosch, went ahead and he was like, would you like to go ahead and send a video so I can go ahead and do my nominees for the Bosch Awards? And I said, you know what, friend? You got it. But where's Raymond? Where'd he go? I'm gonna be like Christian. Where did he go?
I also got contacted by Nick. I
did. No, that was you who contacted you.
I did text
you. We're saying you didn't contact us.
I'm just saying I got contacted too.
And if we're gonna get shit off our chest,
by Nick.
By Nick, yes, I was also contacted.
I need to go in contact with him and tell him to revoke your bullshit.
That's right.
Yeah, put Joe in there instead.
Yeah, and if we're gonna get shit off our chest, I contacted all the fucking knuckleheads and told them to give me ways and how we're different than everyone else, and I have yet to find one way for people.
Is that what you wanted?
Yes, I wanted.
I
wanted to make a video.
That was a legit thing, because sometimes when we'd be saying things in the podcast, we'd be like, he's so funny.
Well, I wanted to make a video to let people know, but like, you motherfuckers, we're different.
We're going to, hold on, we apologize because, sometimes, I think both me and Gigi laughed when Toast sent that message.
We laugh at a lot of things that he'd be saying.
Because sometimes we just think it's a joke, but this was not one of those times.
It's not one of those times at all. It's okay.
Okay. We just need to get that off for the fans to know that.
Not everything I say is a joke.
See, we laugh at things. But we apologize, Tom. We will be sending you.
I'll be serious.
So what I would say is that maybe since, I just cracked something. Maybe.
Yo, you heard that on the mic too. Oh, shit. Are you good?
Oh, my God. Did you?
I was like, ooh. So you hear something crack on the minute 36, 20 seconds. Go back later. You just hear click. Something cracked.
I'm sorry, y'all. I did not go to my appointment for my chiropractor this week. That's going to continue maybe another 2 weeks after the holiday season.
Yo, after what happened last time, I don't know. You should take a little break. So you don't fucking, you're worse when you come out of the car.
Yo, let's not talk about that, all right?
Yeah.
My guy legit fucked me up, and he was like, I hope you feel better. And I'm like, I know. Maybe the Knuckleheads needs to do their own award show.
Am I allowed to be on that after I didn't ask for?
I don't know, Ray. Maybe the Knuckleheads is looking like this right now.
Yo, you hear the dog in the background? That's Ray's dog running away from him, coming to us.
Yep.
Because the dog is gonna set the nominee. Best puto all the year.
Word. And we did awards last year, and I try to make that shit special, and we got copyrighted all over the fucking place. So, were you showing us an empty couch?
No, it's a dog sleeping.
Oh.
Wait, can you see the dog? Yeah, you can see the dog.
We see the dog.
Alina. Before we couldn't. I just saw the couch.
No, yeah,
dog. Wow.
Alina.
Now you just see the painting. Look at the painting. Yo.
Oh, that's right, Mr. Loki. Let him know, baby.
Thank you again, Mr. Loki, for the support. But yeah.
Oh man. Okay. Oh, I'm getting my that's greenery great. Ready. So if I get off camera, y'all already know I'm just pulling up here.
It's all good. It's all good.
Apparently, some I get love and support from my family, but then they start seeing me smoke a blunt, and they're like, "Is she snacking a cigar?" And I'm like, "Something like that."
Yes. You know. So are we ending the show at 11:30?
I thought we were supposed to.
Wait, what? Wait, were we supposed to start this show at 8 to end it at 11?
Yeah.
I thought we was going to just keep it at 9 and go to 11.
Whichever works, I guess.
Oh, I just got on.
That's what I'm saying.
You know what? How do you feel?
We could go to 12. Fuck it. And next week we'll go to 11. Because Ray got an interview on Tuesday.
My bad. I'm still doing the show on Tuesday. It's just I would be.
Are you Ray? Because you wasn't there this Tuesday.
I was at dinner.
I'm gonna be a little late. I'm at dinner.
Yeah.
You had a 24-hour dinner, Ray?
No. It's just we ended up then having some drinks, and then by the time I got on,
dinner and drink.
Right? You don't drink while you're eating?
No. Huh? You know how Spanish people are. We start eating, then we start drinking afterward, and then it just time goes by. My bad.
Shit.
By the time I got home, I was like, I think they're about to end. Yeah, they'll be all right without me.
I'm still here. Okay.
So, JT, I want to get your opinion on what we said before you came back.
Yeah.
So we had options.
Yeah.
It was either CM Punk and Seth, and Cody and
Roman,
or CM Punk, Cody and Seth, and Gunther and Roman at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Damn.
I don't, Mr. Loki. I see them more. And by them, I mean the knuckleheads.
It's a liar.
Give me a second.
You know what's funny? When Gigi came on, we had 8 viewers. When she turned off her camera, we got 4.
Damn. What's going on here? We know who the
worst
part is. we peoples too. You know what I'm saying?
It's because we don't have red hair. We got to dye our hair. That's it.
I'm about to dye my hair red.
Yo, I used to have red hair. It was nice.
Yeah.
I got to dye my hair again.
Don't you do it red.
Word.
There's only one.
I can't have red hair again?
It can only be one.
You can't even have blue hair.
No, can't.
I did do blue hair once. I did not like it. I looked like a fucking Smurf. It was not good.
You don't like looking like Ninja?
No, his blue was like a nice light blue. Mine was fucking like fucking Cookie Monster blue.
Oh shit.
It was this fucking blue. That's what my hair was. It was this fucking blue.
So it was mine at one point, and then I just, you know what it is? Blue is it's more of an upkeep than red, I feel like sometimes.
Yeah.
Maybe not. But then on top of that, after a while, blue is essentially associated with like depression and shit like that.
Yeah.
And it doesn't, it after a while, when it starts getting dull, it kind of just like, it brings your mood down. At least for me, it did. I'll say that. Like, I just got like really tired of it. It's just, it just kind of consistently brought my mood down. And I was like, you know what? This is why I went with something loud and vibrant. And red was always a good color on me. It never failed me. It never did me wrong. It kind of just added on to my personality. And I really like it. And I think it's going to stay on for a while. Now, to answer this question, how can you not want to have Gunther and Roman Reigns? I feel like the only person to take away Roman Reigns' title range is indeed Gunther. He's athletic as him. He has this aura where first and foremost, Roman Reigns, there's some prestige to that title that he holds.
Yeah.
There's no denying it. And if y'all want to deny it, y'all go fuck yourselves, okay? The man has been champion for how many years now? Three? Going on to four?
Yeah, we're going on 4 years.
Yeah.
Okay? This is the year where...
Jesus, yeah, we're going on 4 years. Damn.
This is the time where Roman either A, loses it. If he does it, it's just so much. There's a lot. There's a lot of X factors.
Yeah.
I see CM Punk taking the title off of Seth Rollins.
Yes. That we agreed on. Me and Ty agreed on.
I do not see CM Punk beating Roman Reigns. You're not the best in the world. You used to be the best in the world. You're not the best in the world. The best in the world right now are the ones that are holding the World Heavyweight Championship.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that even goes to Seth Rollins as well. Seth Rollins can consider himself as the best in the world. Sorry, Lay. It is what it is. But he is holding the championship title, and it's not because of, because he can't get no other title than Roman. Nobody can get any other title than Roman.
No.
All right.
In his way, he's making that title as valuable
as he can.
So, yeah. It's that thing.
He's literally working with what he can work with.
Yeah.
while still feeling hurt, while still feeling injured. Like he said, no one is ever 100%.
No, especially in this business. You're not going to, unfortunately, be 100% ever until you finally take that break. And even then, your body is now starting to decompress. So that's when you feel everything. That's when it's like, oh, man, I didn't know I could feel pain under my toes.
Well, oh, man, I didn't know. I heard that crack out of the crack that hurt around the world.
Wait until Seth fucking heals and that broken back of his.
That's what he's going to feel his back the most. And that's what it's like, oh, fuck. But because this is the card we had said when you were gone was if they do it this way. So Seth versus Punk, Roman versus Cody 2, LA Knight versus Randy.
Yeah.
The Usos collide. Gunther versus somebody, which more than likely will be Miz.
That Miz.
And then we're still trying to figure out what they do with the tag titles.
And are we planning WrestleMania? Is that what we're doing?
No, I'm just throwing it out because it starts now. This is Rumble is usually where we start to see where they're going with this. Mm. And it's like, I still think it's Jade and Rhea for the title at Mania 2.
I was about to say, I think Jade comes out for Royal Rumble. Oh, what's up, Dream Match? How you doing?
Que lo que, Dream Match? What's going on?
Jade comes out at the Royal Rumble and she wins the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
That's that right there. And she comes out as number 30.
Yeah.
You know? If not, she comes out as... No, you have to have his number 30.
Yeah. You also have... I really hope they do it, though. I hope they have AJ come out in the Rumble. Just for the fucking pop. That would be amazing. Do that pop. Also, I forgot, they still have to establish Damage Control versus the Force Horsewoman, which now might be in limbo if Charlotte isn't cleared by then.
Fuck. That's another thing. There's a couple injuries right now.
Yeah.
On Charlotte.
Yeah.
We don't know how severe her injury is.
Yeah. What exactly are they saying it is, though? Is it a knee injury? Is it a concussion? Because she did fall on her neck, and it looked like she went head first down.
It wasn't her neck. If you look at all the videos, she was kind of like favoring the leg. She was favoring
She fell, you could tell it got caught on there, but it's like she also landed fucking on the mat.
So Flair injured her knee during her match with Asuka on WWE Friday Night SmackDown.
So it wasn't the fall off the ropes?
It says the belief is that the injury may have occurred when she executed a moonsault off the top rope onto Asuka, who was near the announcer's table. They also hit her head on the table.
Yeah. You know what the thing is that when you're watching it back,
yeah,
it happened during commercial break.
Yeah.
So no one saw it except for you were there live. And if you did see it, you saw it via online.
Yeah, the clips or something.
Like that. Social media.
Yeah.
Because
from that clip, that's what I'm getting. The angle, it looks like no matter what, she's falling fucking hard on her head/neck. So that's what I thought.
How many times do you think her head would have went through the fucking headboard? All right. That's right.
Yeah, I just saw that pull off.
With that being said, Jade Cargill, in my opinion, wins the Rumble. Comes out as number 30, wins the Rumble. That is my prediction. That's what I'm saying. And who is she going to go up against? It depends on who is the women's champion at that time. Like you said, Mommy, Rhea Ripley, it would be...
I feel like that's the best pairing. Because by then, I would assume if they do this 4-on-4... By then, Io loses her title. But again, I don't know what they're going to do now. We might have to, unfortunately, see a 3-on-3 damage control match if Charlotte isn't cleared by then.
I mean, that's that. But kind of circling back to like CM Punk, though.
Yeah.
Do we see CM Punk win the Royal Rumble? Or do we see Randy Orton? Because time is precious with Randy.
I don't think Randy needs the Mania match yet, though. That's why I said Randy in LA, because I feel like they teased that a bit last week. At least something with them of like, oh, you start doing the, okay.
You see what I mean?
In there, kid.
This is where I made that reference to when CM Punk came and he came out of the pit. Everyone fucking braked.
Yeah.
All the momentum of all the stars that were here before Orton and CM Punk just did a fucking nosedive break.
It did it to Randy. Randy's momentum. And it was like.
Yeah. Jey Uso's momentum failed. Drew McIntyre's momentum failed. The Judgment Day momentum failed.
Where do we see Jey Uso on the WrestleMania card now?
Oh, no, it's still him. No matter what, I still think it was going to be Uso versus Uso.
Brother versus brother?
You possibly do all three.
I mean, they did say that. I guess they just want to get it one and done.
You got to get it out of the way.
I mean, the Bloodline is still essentially a hot faction.
Yeah.
They're still a hot commodity. They're that it, once you bring, you know, all of that through. Now, what would be insane is to have Sami Zayn. But Sami Zayn is taking some time off. Of course, we're going to see him by the time the Royal
Rumble. Oh, so he is taking time off.
Yes. Okay, he's been written off. He's been written off script.
So that's how you take him out of WrestleMania. Because I was asking, too, if you look at it, the only problem with all this, too, is now what do you do with Kevin Owens and what do you do with Sami Zayn?
But if Sami's off, then... I said Sami Zayn versus Rhea Ripley and Kevin Owens versus Logan Paul.
Fuck, we got Logan Paul.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about that nigga.
Another Mighty Kong.
You know what? WrestleMania.
What? Is he
fuck
holding
it.
A title?
He's a United States champion.
Oh, that's right. He took the title off of Ray.
Yeah.
Fuck it. This is what you do. Logan Paul defending the U.S. title against the other best celebrity wrestler ever, Bad Fucking Bunny. That is your U.S. title match for WrestleMania.
I'll pass. It's because I don't want to see Logan Paul and Bad Bunny go at it. I'll pass.
I'd rather watch two high school girls fight.
Respect the craft, Ray.
Yeah.
It's a hard fucking pass. Move the fuck on.
Word. I'm going to be right back. But yo, Dream, before you go, we need a shirt. R-Truth versus Santino Marella in a fucking promo. That's the dream match right there. Holla at me.
I feel like that's happened before, though.
I think it happened.
It didn't happen on his fucking shirt, Ray.
Oh,
listen to Gigi.
Didn't happen on his shirt, Ray. Listen to me.
My bad. But no, I think that I don't want to see it happen. I've been told this match probably is going to happen a few times now.
Oh, what? Logan and Bad Bunny?
Yeah.
And No.
I don't want to see it ever. No. But
no. I think that we need to cut this shit already and give the fucking belt to Ricochet. Finish that bullshit ass story.
Oh yeah, they never did finish that story.
No, they didn't. I think it is long overdue for Ricochet to have some type of redemption.
No, right? Not
in honor for his fucking girl. I'm down for Bad Bunny versus Logan. You just
it's gonna happen. That's the sad part. It's gonna happen. If they go back,
why? Because both veins fighting each other. It's a celebrity death match. We are bringing the MTV celebrity death match.
Okay. There's also
it's a live movie, folks.
You know what? Now that we're talking about dream matches and all that, because Dream is in the chat. How about this? The only way we don't get fucking Punk versus Seth. Punk versus Austin at WrestleMania.
Who? Austin? Punk
versus Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He wrestled last year, and he says he's ready to wrestle again. He says he's ready for one more. I think that is the only match you can give Punk, and he wouldn't complain about not being in the title match.
Who, The Undertaker?
No, Punk versus Austin.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yes.
Mm.
See? Dream agrees.
Here's the thing.
Dream agrees with me, damn it.
Yo, listen.
You have to think about it in this perspective. Yes. Okay? Pepsi Punk. All right? Yes. Our own ECW champion when, again, don't forget who the original Paul Heyman guy was. Okay?
Yes.
To have Punk, you have, and I'm not thinking about Punk right now. I'm thinking about the whole thing.
Spectrum of it all.
Day one-ish. Yeah. All right? If you want to fucking start that. All right? Since day one. I'm thinking about that punk and the journey that has come all the way to where we're at now. Even the messy shit. Because you know why? The messy shit is the shit that kept him fucking relevant. No. And I hate to say it. He's a good wrestler, but the messy shit has kept him fucking relevant.
Yes.
He's good on the mic. He's fucking great on the mic. His wrestling skills, he's not a spring chicken. He ain't the old ECW champion that we once had way back in the day and whatever the case may be. But that doesn't go ahead and take away that he was. And he still has that particular person, that little fire in him to do so, to sell it. Why? Because he likes to sell stories.
Yes.
All right. He can deliver on a promo package with Paul Heyman.
Yep.
He can. It you could agree to disagree. I know Lay is out there knocked out, but he hears CM Punk's name from my mouth and he's like, fuck GG. Like, you know, he's twitching in his sleep because he says, fuck that guy. But you know what? That guy is getting the fucking check. That guy can draw more controversy than any fucking wrestler right now. WWE has this shit in the fucking bag. Yep. Tony Khan is losing money this overall year. Why? Because he made investments that his ass couldn't cash. His ass couldn't cash. Yeah. It cashed, but not in a positive route. It left them in a negative. Why? Because he fucked it up. Tony Khan is not a good businessman. All right? There's a difference. There's a major difference. With CM Punk in the fucking... With CM Punk it being in WWE, they don't have to fucking let shit... Like, you see how fucking AEW is consistently trying to bring WWE's name into this.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Punk doesn't have to do that. He just does it for fun and for shits and giggles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, and that's what I was saying earlier, that it's one of those where we look at it. For WWE, they didn't do it for competition. They just did it because they could. This is just a, let's be petty. Let's just see if he wants.
Let's be petty and make more money than them.
Yeah, that's
all. You like making money? I like making money. We just had a deal. We're merging.
You know, to be honest with you, if you really think about it,
yeah.
WWE's competition is the UFC. Because they merged with Endeavor. So yeah, they got to show that they're just as profitable or more than profitable than the UFC. They're all under the same umbrella.
Well, they have to at least prove that they're it was worth the investment, in a sense.
Right.
You know, so that they give a fuck about AEW.
No, but that's the thing. For Tony, this is now a competition. Because Tony's now like...
Since day one, it was a competition. Yeah. Even like, for Cody, it was a competition.
They signed this guy. They got the other guy. All this. Now it's like, fuck. For Punk, Punk's going to play around. Because now it's fucking... He knows everyone's going to tune in every time he has a live.
And if you think about it, and if you really fucking think about it, Punk has worked on ESPN.
Yeah, and Fox.
And I'm saying ESPN and Fox.
Yes.
Yeah. So with this whole merger as well, and the great partnerships that they all have in between, we don't only get Punk in the ring, but we get him in other sports as well. So even if his shit doesn't work out in the wrestling ring, it can still fucking work out.
Yeah.
And that's always a W. And on top of that, with CM Punk, there is a very, very... possible, strong, possible, or even weak, moderate, I don't know. I want to say strong. I just want to keep it flowing. Where we can get AJ fucking Lee in the Royal Rumble and back on the women's division that not for nothing, this is the women's division that she was asking for.
Yeah. Again, even if it's a one-off, it's still something.
Yeah.
It's still that moment. It's still... holy shit, this is what he does. It's something like that. Let's get back. Let's not do that.
Yo, we
let him not do that though.
He's the man that beat him.
Let's not do that.
If the guy that beat him in the UFC can wrestle, then CM Punk got a good chance.
I still don't know if that guy can wrestle. Let me not say anything because I have to commentate him February 10th. Heart attack. Mike Jackson will be back in the building.
Yo, this guy has more cheap pops than fucking...
No, that plug everything, man. Fuck it. This is what I do.
That Mick Foley over here.
This is what I do. But, again, with all that, Punk draws in money.
And,
Punk
and,
draws in that attention. It draws in...
And also...
Yeah.
The machine of the WWE knows how to promote it because Tony Khan did what everyone wanted as a fan. Oh, they released all these people. Now we get to see them in AEW. We get to see how they really are. And none of those people that he signed from the releases did anything other than what they were doing to WWE, just wasting space.
No, but that was the problem. You know what it is? Because he was signing them, but not knowing what to do.
But
when you look at all those people that he signed, who got themselves over?
But also, here's the thing. Also, Keith Lee, nothing. He did nothing with him. To Ruby Soho, how many title shots did she get to lose?
Yeah. No, that's what I'm saying.
She proved that these people that the WWE couldn't do nothing with had nothing to do. We can't do nothing with them either.
I mean, not for nothing. We should have known it was going to be shit. Especially when Tony Khan decided to go ahead and purchase ROH. And did absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Tony Khan knows how to book matches. He does not know how to book a story. Tony Khan cannot book a story. Tony Khan's problem is booking stories, making a storyline fucking... Yeah. His storyline lasts 2 weeks. All right? The longest storyline that he has right now going on is for this the tournament shit where everybody's getting points, which not for nothing. It should have been like that continuously since day one because that's how you keep your track record.
Yeah.
This tournament, though, it's like they kind of fucked it up. Like this was supposed to be their version of the G1, and it just looks like it's all over the place. But we'll get to that.
I mean, Swerve, when are they just gonna have? When are they gonna just have Moxley winning? Because I don't.
Oh man, Swerve with Moxley's match though.
That was good. Swerve, but that's what I was trying to get at was Swerve got himself over.
Yeah.
Between Swerve and Nana, that was that guy that showed, give me the ball and I'll fucking take it, and he fucking did. He took and fucking ran with it. Because that act right there, that has been the act they have. Outside of the fucking Kennys, Young Bucks, etc.
And Toni Storm.
Yeah, well, Toni Storm was another one who she found something and made it fucking work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's all you need is to fucking let them actually do something. And also be willing to put the machine behind. That's something WWE knows is, hey, if you know what you're doing, we'll put that machine behind you. Punk, legit, all he wants, give me the mic, give me time. And he did it 3 times last week, and we cared every single time.
But show the designated fan.
Yeah.
He wants CM Punk to wrestle already. He had the same issue with CM Punk in AEW. He's like, when this fucking guy going to wrestle? He's been talking this whole time.
He doesn't need to wrestle.
No, no.
Not on a weekly basis, because that's what he wants.
Yeah.
But that's the best thing, though. You know, with show's mentality of that is a lot of people. What that drives, though, is that hunger for that. So when Punk finally wrestles, it means more. Because now it's like, okay, now we're finally going to get it. We're finally going to get it. Now it also drives people to now, if you want to see him wrestle, you got to go to that MSG show. Because that's the first time he's going to wrestle. You want to see him actually wrestle on a live WWE event? You have to watch the Royal Rumble. That's probably where he's going to fucking come back.
I'm going to really... That's MSG. I think I get out of work at 5. It starts at Tuesday. 7, I think.
Oh, yeah. It's a Tuesday this year. Jesus.
It's a Tuesday.
Yeah.
A fucking Tuesday.
So it's a Tuesday. So it's going to start at 7. Not for nothing. That would be a show... I don't like to buy. I like to buy tickets when I know it's going to be worth it.
Yeah.
But sometimes, especially now in MSG, you're better off just buying the tickets the day of.
Yeah, because especially the tickets get fucking cheap as hell day of. Yeah.
And it's MSG. The last time I waited for last minute tickets, I bought it, had a fucking moment. I said, fuck it. I want to go see WWE today. MSG, I'm going. Boom. Floor tickets were a hell of a lot cheaper than the tickets that were like, I don't know, two sections up. And I was looking at those tickets, you know, prior. You know, looking at those tickets prior. Okay, let's see what they are now. Oh, this is what they're selling. What's the floor selling? Oh, I just need two. I'm not going in a big group. Once it hits three or more, that's when it gets expensive. Like,
yeah.
Yo, these tickets are expensive, though. I'm looking at them now. This section right here.
Oh, fucking, my nigga, I can't see shit.
$361 a ticket. That's for
this. Oh, wait, thank you for zooming in.
Yeah, you cannot see.
Okay, so that's not floor seats.
Yeah. No. Yeah, that's the section behind the floor. 361 tickets. And then the section, I think, above,
279. That's not bad for
279,
though.
Dude, I remember when these shits was $80 a ticket.
Bro, I do too. Right. I was like seven.
Shit, how old was
I? The only reason why they're trying to draw in that much money is because of the name drop.
But also,
it's
Christmas time right now. So it's like people are going to buy these tickets as the fucking Merry Christmas, here are your tickets. But they're going to have a bunch of tickets day of that people just didn't buy.
And they got these tickets. The
cheap as hell.
For,
yeah, those tickets.
Bro, I'm telling you, day in their 20s. Of.
Watch.
Those day of.
Yeah. Damn, that's all the way by the.
Because if you think about it, not that many people are buying WWE tickets for the day after Christmas.
Yeah. No, and so many people are going to resell because they're just going to be like, I can't fucking make it. It's Christmas. Like,
right, we're still wrapping gifts in other people's houses now.
Yeah.
We're still making the time. It's smart marketing by the WWE.
Yeah. Fucking on Christmas, I'm going to look at the prices and yeah. Decide. Like on Christmas, I'd be like, you know what? We out to fucking MSG.
And it's MSG. Who wouldn't want to go last to last time wrestling I went show to, at MSG?
And MSG was the 2012 holiday show. That was the last show I went with my dad. It was one of those.
Which one was?
The Hogan anniversary one.
That was the last time you went there?
Yeah, that was the last one I went.
What was the main event?
Fuck.
Because the last time,
fucking main event.
If I'm remembering correctly, the last time I went, the main event was Seth Rollins versus John Cena in a tables match. And this was when Seth Rollins was a part of the corporation.
I know Cena was on the card. I don't remember if that was the match.
And Santino kind of like officially retired.
Oh, shit. Trivia.
I remember.
I know the last time I went to the Garden, AJ Styles won the title against Kevin Owens.
Shit, that was more recent than us.
Yeah, I don't even think AJ.
Yeah, no, I mean, come on.
Well, no, because I've been to the Barclays. more recent, but to MSG, that was the last time I went.
No, wait. Was the last time I went was AJ Styles versus Randy Orton?
We don't know. Who is this bull motherfucker?
I don't know. I don't know.
Hold on, I'm trying to see because I
know Brock Lesnar was there.
Was he?
Yeah, I think so.
Are you sure?
Yes, because
I'm going to question you. Are you sure? How sure are you?
He either wrestled Shane McMahon or Kevin Owens.
That don't sound like you're so sure right now.
I'm 100% sure that I remember something, but I'm not 100% sure what I remember.
No, the main online was fucking Randy versus Bray Wyatt. That was the main online.
Shit.
Yeah. That was the main online.
It might have been the year before
the first Grand Slam.
That was the one I went to.
That was
this was 2015, not 2012. All right. I'm looking at the year now. Yeah, it was 2015 that I won.
1986. Maybe.
What?
1986.
Stop. Stop. No. Stop.
My brother would know.
Essentially, we went a decade overtime, right? By 10 minutes.
No, Pat, you're supposed to be...
For those who don't know and that are still somehow watching with us, we appreciate one that you're watching, like, share, comment, subscribe, let everybody know we're still here. I'm not doing that Instagram again shit. we still gotta work it anyway.
Yeah.
I digress. And coming into the new year, is that we should just say that coming into the new year because we're just there anyway, might as well just fucking get on out. We will be starting at 8 and end at 11.
Yes.
I'm saying this with this much confidence because the person who's running it is looking at me like, I don't know. Does that sound like a good time or does it not sound like a good time?
Because the man that suggested that, I don't see is here. And I'm talking about Kenny. And
I love Kenny. I don't think Kenny's still gonna be here. Yeah,
but I'm saying I think if we're gonna start at 8, then it's gonna be a 2-hour show with me and then you guys are gonna pop up. Because Ray got his special guest.
But he's always doing his interview.
So yeah, but you don't finish.
If I do it at 7, I'll be done to be able to jump in on this.
Yeah, 15 minutes with me is 2 hours. It's 2 hours of people's lives. I suck the life out of people because of my ranting.
I will be.
But listen, you want to just do 9 to 11? Because I can see Gigi's face. Like, yo, listen, I don't think I'm going to get here at 8. Not all the time.
No, for sure. No. This space is because I'm high. But no, that's actually for sure that I know I won't. I mean,
yeah.
I barely get on at 9 as is. Yeah. Yeah. I try. Listen, mom life, all right? I be lifing over here. Child life, and my child don't know, like, oh, mom's up. I can stay up too. Bitch, go to bed. Nope. Fuck. Can I hang out with you? Yo, she didn't piss me off today. I was going to let her curse you out, but she pissed me off today, and I was not having it. I had a legit mom moment. I was like, yo, what the fuck is your problem?
Oh, shit.
I didn't yell. I just looked at her real stern. She said, I'm so sorry. Give me my phone. You ain't calling your friends today no more. Go on your tablet. Go away. Then she asked me later, after she felt better, we made up, whatever the case may be. Can I curse Alto today? And I'm washing dishes. And I'm like, no. And that's because you pissed me off. And you should have known better.
Facts.
You don't get to have that privilege of cursing out your friend on live air. Consequences. You must pay for what you have done. This is the consequences that you must owe to mom because you're fucked up.
What's going on, bad blood?
That's it.
And what she kept doing was walking away from me. And I'm still talking to her. Like, where are you going? I'm still fucking talking to you. Yo, by the third time, I was like, you know, once. Yo, come back. 2. Yo, I'm not even done talking to you. 3. No. Get your ass back over here. I'm not done talking to you. Like,
the fact that you let her do it 3 times is like, my mom would have killed me.
I sat because I was sitting. So I just got home. I'm on the couch. I'm detoxing by playing a stupid game that I am now like really fucking addicted to because it kind of works my brain in different fuckable ways. Like, but it's wild. And I was like, yo, let me talk to her. I haven't, whatever. She's asking me questions. I'm listening to how she's talking to her friends. And it's like, you sound mad bossy. You sound mad annoying. And I can hear a friend, like, can you please stop? And Riley wouldn't stop. And I was like, yo, respect your friend. She said, you mean respectful. Be respectful. This is shit we're talking about. She could be disrespectful to you, though. It's okay. It's just when I allow it.
She has to earn it. Like,
and expect that at least for her to get something out of her chest before the year ends, because it's only right. It's only right.
You know what's funny? That's what's simmering right now, is just the amount of fuck yous that are coming.
Especially with the way she did her hair.
I'm building it up for her. Just like the way Simon Miller is building up, you know, up the coming up of the podcast, you know?
It's about to be the fucking roast of Toe.
Yeah, speaking of Simon Miller, Bad Blood, what's going on with your boy? I went on his show on Monday, and I called out Simon Miller. I'm not hearing nothing from him. I was on the Roundtable podcast after Raw. I called out Simon Miller. What's going on? We're going to have a one-on-one match. Do I got to Sir Wilkins this thing or what?
What?
I don't think he's ever coming, bro. I'm going to be real.
I got a legal document,
bro. Did you write it in all caps?
Yeah, he wrote it for me. He wrote the fucking message for me.
You know what? At this point,
write it in bold. Can you write it in bold?
Shit.
No.
At
this point, we're going to fucking call out the guy that beat him up. We're going to call out Joe Hendry. Joe Hendry, come on the podcast.
Sit. We just spent 4 hours talking shit about Simon Miller.
You know what, though? You're going to have to, like, run that back, run that clip back. On the page, tag Word. Simon Miller in it. Just run it back. Repost that Word. Shit on your page. Run it back. Like, nah. Don't let my tips of the day bury the fucking contract you got with us, man.
Facts.
He's ducking so.
Damn.
Wow.
Yo, Jones do be doing that, though. Jones do be doing that.
So let's get back on track really quickly. Gotcha. We got Punk on Raw. We got Cody. We got Jay. Where does Cody fit? I'm at the point where I think we're just going to add Cody into the mix between Seth Rollins and CM Punk at WrestleMania.
Yep.
Because, I mean, what? You're going to have Shinsuke Nakamura? Shinsuke Nakamura is going to have a match. And
oh, wait. Yeah. What do you do with Shinsuke and fucking Mania?
Jesus. You put him in the Andre Battle Memorial.
Oh, yeah. That's a thing. Is that going to finally be on WrestleMania this year?
No, probably not.
SmackDown before?
Mm-mm.
Which is just dumbest shit I've ever heard of.
They have two nights and they can't fit in this Battle Royal?
Then the fucking Battle Royal is like fucking 5 minutes on SmackDown anyway.
It's a Battle Royal.
Yeah. But no, we also talked about
the only person that wants to be in a Battle Royal is the person that's getting that W.
Yeah.
That's it. And even then, because they don't know what to do with after it.
Yeah, they don't do nothing with the winner.
Not much. They acknowledge it for a few weeks. The person acknowledges it for the rest of the year until it withers and dies out.
Yeah, what? It's like Baron Corbin and Bobby Lashley, the only ones that won it and are still there.
Yeah, because Claudio got. Yeah.
But good for Baron Corbin doing his thing in NXT, though.
Yeah.
I like to
get I like him in NXT.
Yeah.
I think it fits him, I think it suits him. Not to say that he gets, you know, lost in the shuffle on the main roster, but it's like he found himself like his own voice as opposed to a character. Bum ass Corbin, rich ass Corbin, you know.
Yeah.
JBL trained me, but then JBL dropped me, Corbin. He mentored me into nothing. You know, he's doing really good. It's, you know what's going to be exciting? Besides kind of predicting who the winners are going to be for the Royal Rumble, it's going to be the surprises. And I'm really hoping now that, and we've seen it within the weeks, this is what it looks like when Vince McMahon is not anywhere near the product right now.
No.
He came back near the product, and then they realized, nah, get this motherfucker out of here.
Yep.
Nah. Old man got old timers. He's not, nope. It's not, nope. We're in a merger now. We can't do this.
The best thing is, it's showing, though, what him being away, it is driving people's attention back to the product.
Yeah.
That was the one thing. We did all agree. If, unfortunately, this doesn't work out and they start losing money, then Endeavor's going to be like, hey, you might want to bring the old man back. But right now it's looking like, I think it's good. I think he doesn't need to be here.
I mean, it also helps when you have your top names out there.
Yeah.
You had, because of Hollywood, by the God of grace, you had Cena come back and The Rock.
Yeah.
Even if it was one night, The Rock is still going to sell something, right?
Oh, yeah. That appearance alone, again, it drives people to be like, right. Oh, I know The Rock. I know Dwayne.
Mm-hmm. And they're still going to go on the website. They're still going to purchase just his shirt. And that's okay because that's a sale on them.
Yeah.
But then you bring back CM Punk. Who's now your number one fucking guy who's selling the merch? My guy's been here for like less than a month and already has the top merch. And if that doesn't get brought up in the conversation with like Roman Reigns at some point, it's like a little also slightly wasteful. I just want to get the promo. I want us to get the match, but we all know that, you know, he's going to get destroyed. I low-key want Solo to fuck up CM Punk.
Now, that's something that I'll be into.
I wouldn't be surprised if they do that eventually. But again, for now, Punk and Roman cannot be around each other.
No.
Because they will be like, you know what? We have to book the match. And I don't want them to, just because of the reaction and the pop, to have Punk be the one to end the ring.
I don't want it. For that particular reason.
Yeah.
But to also kind of run back the whole Paul Heyman story.
Yeah. Because there's so... That's the worst part. Because there's so much they could do there. Because they could do the Paul cost Roman. You could do all this and that. And it's like, no.
Right. We did that, though, already with Brock. Yeah. And I felt like that was more of some type of significant feel to it because it is Brock Lesnar. We've seen Punk and Heyman, but sometimes when you think about Paul Heyman, the first person you think about is Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, that is the, as far as WWE goes, that is the Heyman guy. It's Brock. Yeah. It will be Brock. If this was WCW, then this is why even Dream Match said earlier, it could be Stunning Steve. Could be a Rick Rude, something like that. But in WWE, it's going to be
Dangerous Alliance.
It's going to be Brock. Well, now it's going to be Roman. But just that tease of Punk, it's interesting to see. But definitely keep them away as long as you can, because there's two. Instead of booking just one big match, you can book two. And they have two nights of Mania to fucking sell out on top of all the other shit they got to sell out that week. So,
I mean, that those two matches would sell out WrestleMania night one and two.
Yeah, if you do the two title matches right there, that's it. You have two Mania main events secured, and then you just book around. You book the rest of it, which with the talent you have, you can't book a fucking stacked Mania card with no need of a John Cena or fucking Rock. So, it works.
There's just a lot to take in. A lot to take in.
And we're only in December. So this doesn't tell us what could possibly happen in a few months' time. We don't know who could possibly come back.
And then, you know what I love is that right now we're just kind of leaving, the WWE is leaving like these little breadcrumbs to go ahead and really kind of drop. I'm going to drop a little breadcrumb here. And I might sprinkle one a little bit over there just to see where people look at for certain things. Yes, we are keeping Punk and Roman far away from each other and everything like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's good to see that we're going to be able to get that down the road if we get there. Because, you know, who wants to work with somebody who's punching people in the face backstage? Nobody wants to work with that.
Yeah. You can't do that in 2023.
Nobody wants to work with that. Kevin Owens, though. Kevin Owens was so happy. Hey, Noble, did you see that? No, he goes, I did it. Oh, yeah. So it's great to see a lot of things, kind of a lot of different opportunities. And I think that's the main thing with CM Punk here. We're going to get a lot of opportunities. And even though it's a big, yo, fuck CM Punk, fuck Logan Paul, fuck Adam Copeland, fuck this and that. We're adding opportunities that we were not being able to have before. And I think that that's a great thing. And I think that people are taking that for granted. You know, storylines are storylines. You're going to be mad forever for a fucking storyline. Be mad is what they want you to fucking go with.
Yeah, the thing is, and this is how you look at it, if you're still watching, then they're doing their job.
Yep.
You're mad, you're happy, you're fucking just questioning everything. But if you're watching, then they're doing their job. And this is why I said, like, my biggest thing earlier, that me and Toe were trying to decipher how to do it the best way, I still think if they really want to get people talking and they want to give a fucking just fuck you moment, and a moment for WrestleMania, you have Cody and Roman happen. You have Cody finish the story.
The fucking story.
You have everything. You have the confetti. You have the theme. You have everything.
Bring the fucking dog out.
Bring the dog out. You then take the dog away. Because then you have Damian ruin the moment. Cody now has to live his own nightmare because he had it. And he lost it like that. Because that would get people talking.
Yep.
Unfortunately, Toe was about to say why you probably shouldn't do that, Toe.
Well, because that'd be the worst fucking reign for Damian Priest. That would solidify Damian Priest just being a transitional champion. But I would prefer if Damian Priest did that to CM Punk.
Okay, Gigi, I asked Toe this, but because this was Toe's idea, I don't know. For you, is him beating CM Punk or beating Cody Rhodes, who just finished the story, which is the bigger moment? Especially when you're thinking about Cody just beat Roman, he just ended that streak. This is now Cody with the title, or Punk that just got back and beat Seth.
You know what it brings me back to?
Yeah.
And bear with me. It kind of brings me back to Roman,
mm-hmm.
Lesnar, and Seth Rollins cashing in.
Yep.
Roman was sure going to win it. Seth took it. Can we see something possible like that? Yes. And it would be for a bigger, to have more meaning to it.
Yeah.
It's more meaningful, unfortunately, to have Cody Rhodes take that L as soon as he got it. Because honesty, Cody Rhodes doesn't need a championship. He just looks good on him with his blonde hair and his Homelander outfit.
Yeah, for the story itself, right? All he needs to do is just win it. The minute he wins it, he could then lose it. That's the end of the story.
And that's the key thing here.
Yeah.
You have to win it because the last person that had it fucking destroyed it, and he's barely doing things right now. He's in mid-card. Yeah. You know, we're going to get him tag teamed up with Grayson Waller because he ain't doing shit either. And these are two arrogant people that kind of go great together. Boom, we'll put them together. But that, I digress. That was a fail. You cannot have two failed men's money, you hear me? Money in the bank briefcase cash-ins. This has to be a W. And Damian Priest cashing in on good old American boy, all right, being a black woman, all right, with a mixed child going up against a Puerto Rican from New York, all right, the Punisher, all right. It would give it more meaning because as much as you have to understand, they want to sell you that Damian Priest is the biggest heel of them all by cashing it in. And what better way to cash it in on the good old love, Cody Rhodes? Oh, my father's sin.
Now, which storyline going beyond WrestleMania in that moment would be more significant for Priest?
It would be Cody. You're going to have to keep building that up just a little bit.
Because, you know, I see if he beats Cody, like I said, Cody is undefeated.
Right. But you know what they do? His entire career, he's undefeated. He's not untouchable, though. That's the thing.
And Seth Rollins have become Voltron. There's no way Damian Priest is going to, unless it's a fuck finish, like Ray likes to say,
Damian Priest is defending that title against Cody. Cody probably wants to put Damian Priest over. Why? Because Damian Priest is the future of running this shit. You don't need a title for Cody to do the shit that he does, EVP status, all right? Because he does that for WWE, but without having to be in that fucking position. And he still gets that money. He still gets that check. He still gets that reaction.
He's over without the title.
That's what I'm saying. You need Damian Priest to get over in the worst way. Because he's a heel with the Judgment Day.
I get it. But I think CM Punk can help Priest out more, looking as like a legitimate champion than Cody would.
No, because Cody's had to finish his story, and Cody still hasn't finished his story. CM Punk is coming back saying, I need to finish my story. Yeah, so did the other guy. Give me something new. Nah, you ain't here to finish the story. You're here to start some shit. There's a difference. Cody came back with a story that we're still waiting. We're waiting on Cody's story to finish the way we were waiting for fucking what the fuck was his name coming to Monday Night Raw?
Veer's coming
to Raw the same pace that Cody Rhodes is finishing his fucking story.
And just like Veer, when it finally came, it ended like that.
Veer is coming to Raw. Cody Rhodes is still your reigning, defending, I need to finish my story champion of WWE. Oh! Fuck out of here!
Yeah.
Yes, the story is still with it. Look, we've been building this story for a minute. Punk just got here. He's rebuilding his story about less than 6 days ago. Okay,
no,
maybe more.
Well, with their story, it's already set because it's a thing of with Punk and Seth. Punk was Seth.
Mm-hmm.
Punk was that guy that came up from the independent circuit. Legit. The funny thing is, if you look at their history, Seth did the same thing Punk did in ROH.
Yeah.
They both were ROH champions and both signed their contracts on the belt saying, hey, so we're going to the WWE. Peace, everybody. So it's like they were the same guy. It's the perfect story right there. They have their story. With Cody, we know what his story is. He just has to win the belt.
Yeah.
No one ever said he had to keep it. He just has to win it.
Just win them.
Just win it. You win the title.
On the paper, it shows that he had it not for long.
Give him 7 minutes. Just give him enough time for the confetti, all that good stuff. Open the champagne, and then Ultra Bridge. That's it. Toad is not like this.
Toad's like, nah. So do you really think that what has more meaning behind a cash in win for Damian Priest is to go with a CM Punk route?
In the long run, yeah.
But
because I think.
But there's a thing.
I think.
And hear me out. Not that many things are really planned in the long run.
No, yeah. I. But what I mean that is, you're gonna have that moment. The Miz cashes in the Money in the Bank and becomes champion. The little girl got that fix in her face. We're all going to remember that. And then the run is going to be shit.
Yeah, just but like that's, the Miz had it.
But
I hate to say it, but that's what wrestling is. It's moments. The fuck. Let's be real with it. Everything is moments. That's
I understand that.
No, but then listen. That, but wait. He has a point, because every time we ask, let's be real. Every time we ask like a wrestler, we ask them, what's your favorite, like, you know, match? And they're like, I don't have favorite matches. I have favorite moments.
Yeah, and that's going to be that would be for Damian. That's the best moment.
Yeah, so Zack Ryder won the Intercontinental title at WrestleMania 2. That was a good moment. And everyone loved the moment. The WWE said, fuck you on Monday Night Raw. You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes yeah, no, those moments... No,
But then again,
get overshadowed with history.
A product that was under the fucking grasp of Vince McMahon, and we have to put these things in perspective.
Because
we don't live there anymore.
I get the moment that Hulk Hogan beat Yokozuna right after Yokozuna won the title from Bret Hart was huge back in them days, but now people hate it. You know, like. This is what I'm saying.
You know is that because we know more now of the story behind it.
So
that's why. We didn't know back then. Back then we were like, holy shit, this is really happening. I'm a fucking kid. But also, holy shit, this is happening.
My
God. When you find out later, though, when you become an adult and very invested still up to this day as we are, you realize all the stories behind it
this is my explanation why I think CM Punk is better, because the moment is bigger with Cody Rhodes, but CM Punk helped make MJF world championship material.
Mm-hmm.
Cody Rhodes did not lift anyone in AEW up. He actually pulled the go-go. He killed the go-go. He had a horrible fucking little thing with his wife and Jade and Shaq.
No.
Brody Lee was already the man when he came in the Exalted One. There was Cody
was also in a different position.
No,
yeah.
But Cody Rhodes now in the WWE, he didn't help position. Jay. He's not helping Jay. He did the shit he did with the Miz was horrible. I think he's gonna overshadow Priest.
More of the image of Cody Rhodes that is on our screens.
What? Yeah.
Instead of noticing the shit, backstage.
I'm not talking about backstage. I'm talking about what we see.
Yeah.
But with CM Punk, I believe if CM Punk was in a feud with Damian Priest. Going after that championship, I think CM Punk would throw up that layup and say, here's your chance to be bigger than you are. And it's up to Damian Priest to be bigger than he is. Where Cody Rhodes has no choice but to be bigger than Damian Priest, because now I got to finish my story again because you stole the ending from me.
No, that would be the end of the story there. And this is the thing. I get where you're coming from with that. But like Gigi said, it is now... We're under the Triple H era. The reason why we hate a lot of these moments is because now we know what happens after. With this, we don't know what could happen next. We can be talking about it right now, and Damian might have the best fucking run ever. He might finally become that heel we expect him to. Or it could be shit. The problem is we don't know where this can go. Yeah. Right now, this is all pie in the sky theory.
Yeah.
Possibly, Damian doesn't cash in on anybody at me.
Real quick.
Yeah.
Dream, was it Cody who gave him the best match ever, or was it those ladders?
It was Cody. The fuck?
My man jumped over those ladders 17 times.
Wait. How about this? Cody Rhodes and Brody Lee. Dog collar match.
I already said Brody Lee was already big coming as the Exalted One. He didn't need to raise Brody Lee like that.
No, he did, though, because Cody Rhodes was a huge name in AEW during that era and during that time. You cannot dismiss that. There's no way you can fucking dismiss that, because guess what? The Exalted One overcame Cody and became the TNT champion. Okay? Wait. TNT. Sorry.
Yeah.
Just making sure I got that
shit. Yeah.
So that helped Brody Lee solidify that he is the Exalted One. The Dark Order was the strongest faction going into the pandemic. Okay? That elevated Brody Lee. RIP, by the way. But that helped him that. All right? Cody didn't take no championship titles because he vowed himself not to, so that way nobody in the back would feel some fucking type of way. All right? There's just so much more that you're just not thinking about. Like he said, Cody made MJF. Yes. Yes, he did. Cody fucking even made Darby Allin. He brought him out of his shell.
The dog collar match between CM Punk and
shell more with Sting, because the similarities of everything is a little bit there.
The dog collar match between CM Punk and MJF didn't show MJF was the fucking main eventer?
No, but that showed it. Cody molded it.
Cody was just his friend.
But
come on, the match he had with MJF was... No, that was Jericho, my bad. But like, when he fucking landed face first into the thing. But... In all honesty, you guys are struggling to give me people that Cody made big.
But again, Cody wasn't Cody's position.
Cody was still a competitor in AEW.
All right, so hold up. So it's not his job.
It wasn't his job there.
So it's not his job to make any of his competitors look good.
No. But you're saying, in the way Punk did. Remember, Punk's coming in as the vet. Cody was still in AEW as a competitor. Yep. Now Cody's coming back to WWE as someone tenured. Now he has that spot that he can't. Cody, when at the time of AEW started, wasn't that guy that could do something like that.
No, Jericho, so why can. Then why give the example of Darby Allin?
Jericho bet that because Jericho was the veteran that was coming Jericho, into AEW.
Why give the example of Darby Allin and MJF if he's a competitor? Because
Cody Rhodes also
because he was able to.
Because you're giving me examples of people who thrived in spite of Cody Rhodes being the bigger name.
Whoa. Why would you say in spite? We're not saying because, in spite.
No, because the thing is this. You guys are making it seem like he built up Darby Allin, but he wasn't allowed to build up a go-go because he was a competitor. CM Punk was also a competitor. CM Punk was the AEW champion. CM Punk still won matches, and he still had one of the most meaningful rivalries with Eddie Kingston. He had one of the most meaningful rivalries with MJF. When he came in and had that garbage-ass match with Darby Allin, at least the fucking... The promos he cut was to push Darby Allin. He wanted to push fucking Jungle Boy before this whole glass shit happened.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for the fact that people were so unprofessional with CM Punk and dealing with the shit that happened in the back, CM Punk could have been the guy that was the measuring stick in AEW and that people used to show that they're worthy of this shit.
Different personalities at the same time. Look how composed Cody Rhodes can be during a situation where you're like, nah, we can't come into terms with our contracts.
Bringing someone in is not what we're talking about, Dream. What I'm talking about is the longevity of the relevance of Damian Priest after he wins the championship.
That's the thing. You still have mommy.
No, because
You have to run this as a faction, and you have to run this faction running Monday Night Raw.
Kofi Kingston, it's going to elevate him. Kofi Kingston had a huge moment at WrestleMania winning the championship, and his run was for shit. Big E, they ruined his fucking title shot with the Money in the Bank when they told everyone he was going to cash it in on that Raw. And he got hurt, but that run that he had when he lost to Brock and all that, that run was kind of for shit.
Again, under
this is what I'm saying.
McMahon's era. You need to give it a chance so it can breathe. We're leaving this era behind. What are we leaving behind in 2023, ladies and gentlemen? Vince McMahon and his era. We're leaving that behind. Goodbye. Good day, sir. We don't need you. Go the fuck this way. Who are you? I don't know, but you need to go that way. Go that way.
But in the same era.
Wait, time out. That is the Vince McMahon era. We are transitioning into a Triple H era.
In the same era, Austin Theory lost his Money in the Bank match to the United States champion.
And then they rewarded him with John Cena.
And he couldn't.
Vince never left. This is why I said in the same era.
Vince is not there anymore. Listen, you can have whoever you want running the show.
Yeah.
In that match, Cena did Austin Theory no favors.
No.
Austin Theory's cashing in and the United States champion did Austin Theory no favors.
Yeah.
Cody Rhodes will do no favors for Damian Priest. Win, lose, or draw. Do no favors for Damian Priest.
I don't see that. I can't see that.
Because my thing is, I get the
Seth aspect. Rollins will do no favors for Damian Priest.
But the thing is, I get the after, but the moment itself is what we're trying
to do. I'm not arguing the moment.
Yeah, so but that's what we need at this point.
Doesn't the aftermath have to deal with the challenge itself? We don't know what... Okay, so boom, we have Damian Priest as our champion. Let's play scenario. Fuck it. We're creating our fucking scrapbook right now. Damian Priest is our Raw heavyweight champion. Okay? Who do we put Damian Priest in a storyline that is not Cody Rhodes, that is not Seth Rollins at the moment either? And I say that because let's just say we give Seth a couple months off to kind of recover that back because we all know about it. Who do we put Damian Priest in a championship that looks believable that can possibly beat him when he is running on a fucking supreme fucking rage of being, well, his essential tribal chief himself?
This is why I said he would cash it in on CM Punk and Seth Rollins.
I'm asking the question of who he will run the champion. I'm giving you the floor of who.
CM Punk.
Let's book him. Okay. And who else?
Yeah, because that's the thing. Now we have to keep going.
Who else?
Oh, so we don't have to keep going with Cody?
Who else? Cody. Who else?
This is also the thing. We also have to remember now, if he wins that title, Cody's technically still a Raw guy.
Yep.
But Cody's out of the picture.
Cody can either A, fuck that guy. B, I'm going to come after this guy. Cody don't matter.
Yeah.
Cody is that chess piece that moves everywhere on the board.
So, all right. So here's the thing. Because the story, you just asked me, Damian Priest wins the championship.
Yep.
Who does he wrestle besides Cody? I said CM Punk. Who else? Okay. We can have him wrestle CM Punk. Then we can have the storyline with him and Finn Balor. And that can run into SummerSlam. But if he beats Cody, there is no who else. He loses that title to Cody.
No.
You have
he loses that title to Cody.
No, that because you're not. Guess what? Cody will take that L
at Mania, not anywhere else. Remember when we do this shit where we talk about pie in the sky and when Vince really never left? I'm undefeated. I'm batting 1,000 when it comes to predictions on how these motherfuckers run. Cody,
Cody will not lose to Damian Priest. Rock is gonna, that's it.
Okay, this is December 14th, 11:49 p.m.
Yep.
WrestleMania, it's 40 next year, right? Whichever WrestleMania it is.
Well, this year's 40. Well, this next 40, one right? is 40, yeah.
So it's going to be 40.
So yeah. WrestleMania 40. We're saying this today, December 14th. Damian Priest will cash in on Cody Rhodes. He will win said title. And he will have a decent win.
I feel like I need to write this down.
We probably should. We're going to clip this. We're going to clip this tomorrow.
We're going to say this.
Again, December 14th. We're saying this. Damian Priest will cash in. Will become the new undisputed Universal Champion. And have a decent reign. Because that's what we're worried about. Is the reign after. Because the moment solidifies. He becomes a historic win of a champion. At WrestleMania. Get the moment. But the reign itself, it can be something. He can wrestle the Randys. He can wrestle the LA Knights. He can wrestle. There's names there. They could do something. I think Cody would do the honors.
Yeah.
If again, his moment was already done. If it goes the way we said, Cody doesn't need to fucking worry about anything else. He got his moment. He got his shine. Even if for 7 minutes, he got his. He got the...
And then on top of that, let's really think about the WWE logic. We're going to run that back.
If.
Right? We always run it back.
Yeah.
Right? So we run it back. And guess what? This time, Cody loses. All right? Again, dirty. First time he closed, he ends up. When Damian Priest wins that Money in the Bank, it's going to be clean. It's going to be dirty, as in for coming in after the match, sealing it over, boom. Yeah. But. It's going to be clean. Now, the second time that Damian Priest goes over Cody, and I am going to say that, Damian Priest is going to go over Cody twice.
Yep.
Within this WrestleMania
to backlash
fever that we're in. Yeah. All right. Boom. But the second one is going to be dirty. It is what it is. Either we get a triple threat match because now Seth Rollins wants to get into it, right? Whatever the bullshit may be. Triple threat matches, we all know. Guess what? Damian Priest is going to win out of technicality because somebody's going to get fucked up and he's going to throw somebody out, pin him, 1, 2, 3. Not a clean win. Why? Because he is a villain. And this is what villains do. This is what villains do. And then we move on. And you want to know what's crazy? There's going to be either Monday Night Raw happening, premium live events happening. And next thing you know, we're already in May.
You know whose story you're telling right now, Gigi? The modern day Maharaja. Because that's what happened with him.
But it won't, because I don't know if you noticed lately, but they're trying to beat records here. Longest reigning champion, boom, Roman Reigns. Longest intercontinental champion, boom, Walter. They are now focused more on the longevity of a champion holding their championship title instead of fucking flopping it around like fucking pancakes.
Hey, what's going on, Krills?
Yerp.
What up, Krills?
That's what my earrings say. Yerp. Yes. So, yeah, this is what we're looking at. The longevity of actual champions instead of flopping it around like pancakes like we did with the women's champion between Sasha and fucking Charlotte.
It's supposed to be real. The one next to you, Gigi.
Me? Oh. Yeah.
On the background.
Yeah, in the background. Yeah.
In
the holiday spirit.
It's supposed to be.
It's dirty. It smells like pan. Saul. Let me stop.
But again, this is, we're all, it's just pie in the sky theory at this point. Like we said, who knows if by Mania, if he even cashes in, by then they might just say fuck us and try to do it at the Rumble. And that's how we get Finn and Damian. They might.
That would be cool too, but I don't know, man. It's just,
there's so many things they could do to be different with it.
I don't want him wasting that briefcase.
I don't either. It's. But again, they will either
Oh, shit.
The fuck was that?
Okay, so that wasn't just here, right?
No. My shit just like went.
Yeah. Yeah, mine did the same thing. Yo, that scared the shit out of me.
Same. Is there supposed to be a solar eclipse tonight?
The power just flicked.
Yeah, no, it definitely did. Wait.
Yeah, my computer fucking
Let's say 11:54 to 11:55. My light flicked. My auto fan went crazy. My main light went off completely. It just boop, boop. It really happened.
My mom just texted me too. Did I see that?
Yo. That was wild. All right. I wasn't ready for that.
I was not ready for that either.
Our game. New York just had a quick power out for a second. Boop, boop.
Yes. Well, then.
Interesting. See, it couldn't take all the heat that we were talking about when it comes to CM Punk and the Damian Priest.
Word.
Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns and Solo Sikoa. It's a lot of wrestling. Oh, and the Devils. Let's just switch over really quickly. We got like the last 5 minutes. AEW, let's just run by this real quick. Matches were great. Swerve Strickland, Jon Moxley, match of the night, match of the week. The Devils. One looks like Wardlow, one looks like Jack Perry. I can't identify the other two.
Yeah, someone immediately said Taven and Bennett instantly. Like, they're not even hiding their head sculpts. Like, it just looks like Matt Taven and Mike Bennett.
Oh, so it's going to be Roderick's next strong.
Yeah.
And that whole kingdom. Kingdom and me want to go.
Big reveal to be at least something where
Adam Cole, baby.
I would hope. That would be great.
Sting is the devil. Sting is tired. Sting just wants to smoke that good shit with Ric Flair now. He's good.
He just can't let Ric Flair cut any promos for him.
Yeah.
I'm not going to even fucking touch that or get into it. Yo. We're not going to do that. Power Surge in New York. Yup. That definitely happened.
It's funny because I'm just looking up power trackers and everything is 20 minutes late. Like, the last update was 11:40.
For what?
The New York power outage map.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't pay attention to that. I don't. Because they never updated on time for that particular reason. I know. I was here. I witnessed it.
You know what I've been here.
We all witnessed this shit together.
You know what it could have been? We was talking so much shit about WWE. Andre the Giant walked past us in the spirit world.
He went through one of my figures.
Because I'm like, wait, did I blink? And then I see Gigi's thing is mad dark, and my monitor turns into the reboot stage. I was like, what the fuck is going on here?
Andre is looking at me. There's a Funko Pop of him. He's looking at me.
Word.
No, that's, yeah. Well, you guys all got to see that live with us.
Yeah, right? So before
let
we get
us know fully... how you felt, because if we felt it and we're all over the place,
yeah,
I'm sure that you do too. So let us know.
Word. And on that note, before everything dies.
Yeah, before we go
in smoke here. Word. It's your friendly neighborhood knuckleheads.
No, I'm still like, I don't know what happened.
We'll see you guys. Hopefully, going live again next week. Instagram. And we don't know what we're going to fucking be doing, but we're going to do it anyway.
That's right.
We're wrestling with knuckleheads. We may or may not have a guest. We don't know. Fuck it. Chicken doesn't roll them.
Peace.